as you wave me goodbye. Cheerio, here I go on my way. Till we meet once again, you and I, wish me luck as you wave me goodbye.
The Esoteric Order of Roleplayers present Achtung Cthulhu, The Secret War, with David Larkins as the Keeper of Arcane Lore.
Give me a smile, I can keep all the while in my heart while I'm away. Once again, you and I, wish me luck as you wave me goodbye.
Anyway.
No more
adventures. Mm-mm. Full up.
And let's adventure.
Yeah.
Still here.
All right. So... right, so first things first.
Roll checks.
Is roll checks.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I haven't done this yet.
Yeah.
And so it's the same thing as Thunder, I want to fail, right?
You want to fail.
And it goes up by one, or?
1d10.
Yeah.
1d10?
Mm-hmm.
I totally have not played this wave so long.
Mm-hmm. Damage track, why did you have to crit instead of fail?
Track, yeah. Oh, my goodness, my library use went up by one.
Mine went up by two.
Woohoo!
7% library use. Yay!
My listen went up by 8, though.
Oh, sweet. I rolled 100 on listen.
Nice.
So since I fumbled that, does that mean I get, like, any extra knowledge?
It does not.
Oh, okay. Oh, shit.
I'm tired.
I'll be quiet.
I walked to the plaza and saw the lowriders.
Yeah.
That's fun. That's right. That was a very cool picture.
I have lots of pictures.
Nice.
Lowriders? Like the lowriders. Motorcycle tape?
No. Cars, vehicles from Española.
Oh, okay.
They were having competitions.
Oh, neat.
Mm-hmm. Hydraulic competitions that I've never seen.
Oh, really?
The bouncing?
Yeah.
I've never actually seen
really?
A hydraulic competition.
It actually got a really fantastic exhibit, too, in the New Mexico History Museum. That's all about the history of lowrider culture.
Oh,
that's right.
It's really nice.
Yeah.
Okay. Look at it.
No, my favorite is they do that too for 4th of July usually.
Okay.
On the plaza have like their whole. Sometimes it's just classic cars.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
But you walked.
Oh, I walked.
Mm-hmm. Oh my God! Flamethrower went up to 60.
A 60 and flamethrower.
64.
64?
Wow.
Damn.
Shit.
That's awesome.
Well, only one of my checks went up, but it went up by 10, so.
There you go. There you go.
I know. I kind of have like half and half.
But... I only have one check.
Really? Oh,
no.
Yeah, that's.
Never
no,
actually,
I didn't
hear your part. You were kind of possessed for the whole session.
At least.
Does that mean that the other guy gets to make those checks?
Yeah.
Dick.
When we find out who he is.
Somewhere in Hyperborea, Sorcerer makes skill check.
Super intelligent fungus.
It's a skill check.
I now know how to drive an automobile. I got a good voice going on this week.
You
I should
do.
Use it.
Yeah.
Work it.
Work it. Alrighty.
Don't forget you can burn luck to guarantee success.
Oh, speaking of that. The Pulp Cthulhu PDF dropped for Kickstarter backers this last week, so I haven't had a chance to go through it. thoroughly, but by our next meeting I will have. So I may be making some additions or amendments.
Right.
One of the things that jumped right out at me is an optional roll to burn luck to assuage sanity loss.
Oh.
So you lose 8 sanity. No, I don't. I burn 8 luck.
Okay.
I kind of like that, you know, because there's a trade-off.
And now
burn 4 sanity and just don't go crazy.
Right.
Right.
Exactly.
Maybe you can do it incrementally.
Avoid psychosis.
Yeah. I'll have to see about that.
Yeah.
No, that's actually a really cool mechanic to have.
Yeah, if you wanted, like, not just automatically flip out, you know, every time.
Because sometimes it's like wildly inconvenient.
Exactly. That's right. And then, oh shit, I'm out of luck the next time you have to make a luck roll, or, you know,
right.
Burn all your luck and you can't burn any more for sanity loss or whatever.
Exactly.
So, I like it.
That sand loss wouldn't have been so bad, but your sand loss.
Exactly. Okay, so speaking of sand loss.
Yes.
We had some people losing sand here and there, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So, you recall that with our last session, you all returned to London.
That's right.
So, if you want, you can... well, actually, I'm going to give you guys some sand just for successfully retrieving the Clypeus. So... Dr. Fenton, get 5.
Oh, yeah. Mm.
Captain Bretz, 5 as well.
That brings me back to my max.
Nice. Well, actually, no, your max is 99 minus your Cthulhu Mythos, so you can actually go above where you started.
Oh, where I started? Oh, really? Yeah.
Just not with psychoanalysis, right?
That's right.
But with, with sanity gains at the end, bonuses at the end of the
campaign. I didn't think I ever knew that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Huh.
Private bucket, you gain 2.
Awesome.
You lost some from that torture.
Yeah, and you marked those down as
I did.
And oh, Jane, they're playing your character's song.
You don't want to set this world on fire.
Just a little bit.
Helga, you regain 4.
Yay. Mm-hmm. So speaking of which,
mm-hmm.
as of last session, I had strength, dex, and movement.
Yes. Okay.
Restrictions in addition to still being below hit points.
Okay, so first of all, you're all back to your max hit points.
Uh-huh. Oh, great.
Because we're going to be rejoining the narrative 6 weeks later.
Uh-huh.
So for Brett's, because your treatment wasn't in a hospital, you're not going to fully recover.
Okay.
So basically, your strength and dex are back to normal, but your move is going to be 1 point lower permanently.
Okay.
You'll just have a bit of a gammy leg.
That's fine.
Yeah.
That was fast, too, I suppose.
Mm-hmm. Yes. wounds tend to, unless you can get them treated right away in a professional environment, they'll have lingering effects.
So. Well, I'm still better than my -2 modifier, so. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, also remember that anytime you advance a skill to 90% or higher, you gain sanity. Mm-hmm. So, I don't think that happened today, but something to keep in mind. And then if you're desperate to get some sanity back, you can always connect with one of the people marked on your friend, family and friends section of your sheet.
Okay. Oh!
That's similar to the trail concept.
Mm-hmm. Yes, exactly.
Sandy pillars.
Exactly.
Speaking of which, David, I just wanted to remind you, I had let you know, I don't think we ever talked about it, for my family and friends, my person ended up being an NPC who taught me something, but the person was never figured out or assigned.
Oh, okay.
So just to say, I totally forgot about it too, but...
Okay. It could be any number of, like, mentors from your army training if you want.
Okay.
You know.
Or
something else, yeah. I mean, it's...
No, it wasn't...
Or just keep it general for now, and if something comes up in the game, say, oh, that's my guy, you know.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because in the thing of the text, it said to be determined by the GM.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
Well, if I spot something, I'll I'll fill in that blank, but feel free to throw it in as well. So yeah, if you want to spend time with one of the family or friends, you make a sanity roll. If you roll successfully, you gain 1d6 points of sand. If you fail, you lose a point and basically fundamentally alter your relationship with that person.
Mm.
So it's a bit of a risk.
It's a bit of a passion roll.
A bit, yeah.
Yeah.
And then you should all have a key connection marked.
Yeah. Okay.
On my those.
Key connection.
Bias. My ideology.
I don't know.
Maybe not. One of the family or friends should be a key connection.
No, I don't think I do.
Okay. When spending time with the key connection, you may roll a bonus die when making your sanity roll to recover san.
Okay. Oh, here she is. Found her. Okay. Ant zero.
Right. All right. So, with that all in mind, the time is October 1939, and Great Britain is at war. London has turned into a city without children. 500,000 children are evacuated out of the city within a week of war being declared.
Out of London.
Out of London.
Okay.
Sent off to the countryside, boarding schools. Mm-hmm.
And three very lucky children are staying with Angela Lansbury in the country.
That's right.
Yes, that's right.
Excellent.
Britain immediately started going over to a war footing, issuing gas masks to civilians. So it's not unusual to see people walking around the streets with little boxes over their, you know, strapped over their shoulders. Mm-hmm. There's a widespread fears that Germany will, you know, resort to poison gas bombing. Italy did it in their Abyssinian War 3 years earlier, so. Is not without precedent. Oh. Petrol is being strictly rationed, as are enforcements of blackout regulations. Very strict, to the point where it's almost impossible to drive at night. Fatalities from nighttime traffic accidents have skyrocketed since blackout enforcement began. And another new sight over the skylines of London and most other major towns are barrage balloons. These giant silver dirigible-shaped balloons that are attached to cables and floated about 50 to 100 feet or higher above the roof line, basically creating a, almost like aerial barbed wire. Mm-hmm. Making it difficult for planes to fly low over the cities.
They have very loud propellers, don't they? Those, is that what I'm thinking of? The balloons that their propellers are so loud that you have to just, you can't hear at all.
No, these are
I saw a demonstration at a Air and Space Museum a few years ago, and it's pretty intense.
Interesting.
Yeah.
As far as I know, these are just free-floating, filled with helium.
Oh, okay. Okay. Mm-hmm.
So, for the four of you and a dozen or so others, these concerns are but a memory. For you are all off at the residence of Alexander, Viscount Towton. you are staying at the newly established headquarters for Section M. Clemens Park, a stately home in the county of Kent. Speaking of loud propellers, it is actually situated near an RAF aerodrome, so it's not unusual to have planes flying overhead at all hours of the day and night. Otherwise, this is your sort of classic. 18th century neoclassical revival style house.
Style.
Exactly. sort of screened off from the outside world by large hedges and fences, rolling perfectly manicured lawns. The ground floor of the house has been converted into a warren of classrooms and meeting rooms. You can still see the discoloration on the wallpaper from where the priceless artwork was taken down and moved to storage.
After hundreds of years.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Okay.
So there's sort of constant chattering of typewriters and comings and goings of agents. Dr. Fountain.
Yes.
Yes, I'm here. You have been brought in at Alec's request to serve in an advisory capacity.
Okay.
On matters of research and, should we say, esoteric mm-hmm. Concerns. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Lizzie, who is not represented at the table today, has been poached by Alec to serve as his private secretary after hearing of her exploits. Lieutenant Commander Riley is on assignment in Greenland currently. And yeah, the rest of you have been fully inducted into the Section M apparatus. So you all have your official patches for your uniform jackets.
They're fancy.
Mm-hmm. Which depict an M formed by the Pillars of Hercules with a sort of sideways S running through them. And yeah, basically your last 6 weeks have been consumed with helping to get the section up and running, analyzing the remainder of the Ehrlichman's journal, and preparing to make your next move. It's obvious that the Germans are on the case as well. From the best you can tell, they're operating off of the copy of the translation of the Black Stone that Ehrlichman gave them, which is not the best translation. Right. He gave them the original translation.
Right. Ha.
Mm-hmm. Indeed, ha.
Suckers.
Oh, Dr. Fountain, due to your studies of the journal,
yeah.
You can give yourself 10 points in Atlantean.
Ooh.
And give yourself a skill check roll for it as well.
Okay. I'll roll that at the beginning of next adventure.
No, right now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good. So add 1d10 to your Atlantean. Okay. And,
I have a question.
Yes.
I remember one of our emails, he had said that, in terms of like learning new skills and languages and things like that, mm-hmm. that was a potential thing we could go for with our comrades. Like Helga, what was it like? Was helping Dr. Mm-hmm. Sharma translate and mm-hmm. so like ended up. So in terms of like learning German and stuff like that, mm-hmm. since we're like hanging out with Helga and also all of these spies and things like that, and
Yeah.
How does that work again, though?
Okay, so basically, Helga has to make a roll to teach it.
Oh, okay.
And then you get 1d10 points in German, basically.
Okay.
Yeah.
That might be helpful, being surrounded by Nazis.
Sure,
everything.
Sure.
Oh, yeah.
For instance.
Yeah. Oh, one other thing, Jen. I realized when we were translating attributes to the percentile system. With 7th edition for education, they don't want education going over 100.
I didn't either.
Yeah. So what are you at?
104.
Oh, so that's
absurd.
So that translates to 94, I think it was. If I'm wrong, I'll check it later. If I'm wrong,
for the purposes of this adventure.
Exactly. Yes. So.
104, you say?
Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
Very clever.
So, Renee, if you want to be teaching...
Yeah, German, what would I roll?
You roll your German.
Oh, okay.
German.
Oh, okay. No, I want to roll below, huh?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Yeah, that's not hard. 62.
Okay. 1d10 points in German.
Sweet. Here you go. 1. Yay! And we said I was a great pupil.
2% in German.
Guten Tag.
Guten Tag. Yeah, exactly.
Alcina's hand.
That is something. I'll take it. It's a start.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay, so. Let's see.
Oh, man.
Mm-hmm. It's a little warm in here. You want me to get the fan going, or?
Only if you're uncomfortable, I'm fine.
Okay.
Quick question. Since we did decide that we are going to Egypt as our first stop, what's the predominant language spoken?
That is an excellent question. Now, obviously, if you're going to be out of the country, it would be Arabic.
Okay.
But you will be going to Cairo first for reasons that will be evident in a moment.
Right.
And in that case, it is English, French, Greek, or Arabic.
Okay. Sounds good. I don't think there's anyone here who can teach a little bit of Arabic.
No, and there's no one in Section M either.
It's a pity.
Yeah. All right.
We'll find someone who can translate for us.
Did you get my email with my vote, by the way?
Did I get your...
I
don't know. What did you vote
for? Oh, okay.
What did you vote for?
Did you vote for not Egypt?
Yes.
Oh, I guess I didn't get it. Jeez.
I didn't get it either.
Oh, really?
You must not have gotten it.
Oh, okay.
No.
What was your vote, though?
For Peru.
Peru.
Oh, of course.
We'll do that next.
Yeah. I'm sure something terrible will happen to the away crew that's going to Peru, and we'll just clean up their mess.
Yeah, they're going to need our help.
Yeah.
We've lost contact with Team Peru. Alright, so here is what Dr. Fountain has gleaned from Ehrlichman's notes regarding Egypt. It is the largest section in his journal in terms of, you know, all the possible places. You know, Egypt has the most research. Let's see here. He talks about rediscovering the DOG archives in Berlin, rediscovering the Black Stone, which he is convinced can still be found in the basements of the Antiquities Museum in Cairo, safely stored away and forgotten about.
This is the Black Stone?
The Black Stone.
Okay.
So this is the stone. It's basically like the Rosetta Stone. It's got two varieties of Egyptian plus this runic script, which is, you know, we're calling Atlantean, for lack of a better term. let's see. According to his notes, Ehrlichman was sure that there was something wrong with the original translation and interpretation of the hieroglyphic and hieratic scripts on the stone.
Okay.
Something he hoped to confirm at some point by visiting Cairo himself to hunt down the original source.
Oh, that.
So there's... basically, there's a lot of stuff on the stone about Amarna, which is the ritual cult center of the heretical monotheistic cult of Aten, the sun's disk, actually, right? Mm-hmm. That Akhenaten tried to promulgate. And so he moved his capital to the city of Amarna. But this artifact, this piece of the Palladian that is sort of related to the sun's disk, right? He doesn't think it's going to be there. He doesn't think it's going to be in Amarna.
Okay.
This is a hunch, but it obviously concerns him deeply because it has no basis in observable facts at his disposal. However, Dr. Fountain,
yes,
you would tend to agree.
Yes.
You agree that Professor Bergdorf, the original archaeologist, you agree that his translation is accurate, but you are also strangely unsettled. Reasons that you cannot.
I think the Bergdorf's translation is accurate.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
But wrong.
Accurate, but wrong.
Mm.
I love
it.
We'll have to see it ourselves, won't we?
Mm-hmm. Around the notes on Amarna, Akhenaten, and his strange reign, there are sketches of a swirling symbol. Mm-hmm. which looked very much like a blemish found on the rubbing taken of the black stone, which is included in his journal, in the sections referring to Akhenaten. There's also a name jotted down in this section. Major Aloysius Blythe Manders.
Blythe Manders.
With the word Cairo and a question mark.
Awesome.
The notes at the back of the journal regarding his suspicions when he was feeling a noose closing about his neck make it clear that those interviewing him were under the impression that the black stone was no more. I believe he did nothing to disabuse them of.
Okay, well, it's in the basement of the Cairo Antiquities Museum, so that's where I suggest we start.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sounds good.
Okay. So, Section M provides you with photostatic copies of the relevant pages from Ehrlichman's journal. So they will be keeping the journal itself at the headquarters.
So, good call.
Good call, guys.
If you learned anything from Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade, you never bring the journal with you.
Should have mailed it to the Knox Brothers. Alright, so.
Yay!
He's out there somewhere. Alright, so. So, you are given a passage on a military transport. So, basically, it's up to you, more military types. You can go, this is not a, you know, this is wartime now. You guys don't have to be all covert. So, you can go in uniform with weapons.
Oh, good.
Oh, neat.
On a war footing, you know.
Yes.
Got your little Section M badges.
Oh, and you know. Both of our uniforms are shorts.
Yeah.
That's exactly. Nice.
Which are like
with
perfect
the
for
knee socks.
Kind of.
Yeah.
Super cozy.
Mine are definitely Marina.
Well, actually, you've got the wool socks. You're barefoot, right? I mean, your uniform's just.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Shorts and.
Maybe some sandals?
Oh, yeah. You know, I have other shoes that I can wear.
You have shoe options.
Yeah, exactly. it's not like when I'm in uniform, I don't have to wear shoes. But. I mean, you know, when I'm on the plane, maybe I'll take them off.
I mean,
Sir, please put your shoes
on. Exactly. Oh, God, no. Yeah. Pretty sure in Egypt they wear shoe shorts. Which are the little, like, curly toed slipper things.
Mm. Yeah. Mm.
Yeah. Ooh. Good shoe option.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, we'll see what they have when we land.
Land, they say. No. This is a naval transport.
Oh, okay. So well, then when we make Earth,
when we disembark.
Italy's not currently in the war, so the Mediterranean is still
peaceful.
Safe.
Well, yes. That's nice.
I doodled some, additions on the map.
You
over
did.
There.
Oh, yeah.
Next time you go over there for a refreshment, you can take a look. Basically, Germany has conquered Poland in less than a month with the surprise assistance of the Soviet Union, which invaded Poland 21 days after Germany did, according to a secret protocol in their non-aggression pact. Mm. So they basically divided the country between them, said, good to see you, went about their business. Mm. Germany still has a non-aggression pact with the Soviet Union. Hungary is a satellite, an economic satellite of Germany, ergo the hatching there. The Baltic states are satellites of the Soviet Union. France and the UK are currently the two major allied belligerents, and nothing has really happened yet.
Right.
In spite of all the rationing, all the blackouts, everything else. There have been some naval engagements, there have been some skirmishes on the borders, but no major offensives or anything is yet to take place. So.
Okay. Constant vigilance.
That's right. But yeah, some in the press are calling it the phony war. So, you board a military transport bound for Gibraltar, then on to Alexandria. Mm-hmm. Your instructions are, upon arrival in Cairo, to check into the Semiramis Hotel.
Okay.
Okay.
This is the headquarters of the Secret Intelligence Service. Not so secret if they have a headquarters. Anyway.
I mean, I'm imagining like a really beautiful but obvious placard just right out front.
Yeah. You know? Secret Intelligence Service. Well, being in Section N, you're privy to that information. It's situated right on the banks of the Nile and is within easy walking distance of the British Embassy, the Antiquities Museum.
Yay! Mm-hmm.
The Gezira Sporting Club, which is sort of an officer's polo grounds and golf course.
Wow!
And the Kasir El Nil Barracks, which is kind of the, you know, where all the, most of the British personnel are being barracked in Cairo. So, the journey passes uneventfully. It is late October. You arrive in Alexandria on October 19th. Stepping off the ship, a sea breeze does little to dispel the still lingering heat. It is, by your standards, well, Helga and Dr. Fountain, uncomfortably hot.
Mm-hmm.
For Private Bucket, not so much.
Nothing.
And Captain Brett's hot.
Okay. I might invest in some different socks. Instead of my, you know, woolen knee highs.
Woof!
Woof!
Yeah.
Maybe don't I look smart?
Apparently they worked. I don't know. Who knows?
Sorry, I've got short sleeves and shorts. So I'll.
Yeah.
I'll be alright.
I want to get one of those tunics we saw at the souk.
Ooh.
Run around in it.
Oh, yeah. A little fez perched atop your head.
Maybe.
I mean, you'd look quite dashing.
I think maybe. Maybe a gallon
pants. A fez is definitely. Yes, it's 30 degrees Celsius, which translates to 85 degrees Fahrenheit.
But it's the humidity, right?
No, it's a dry heat.
It's dry heat. Even by the river?
Right next to the Nile?
Well, in Alexandria, actually, I imagine it would actually be.
Because the Nile's.
And the Nile's.
The Nile's not
even away.
Really? I thought it was kind of. Yeah.
That was just like a little line.
Like the Santa Fe River. It's underground at this point.
It's a creek.
Yeah, it's a creek. It's a perfectly legitimate creek.
There's nothing below creek, right?
Rivulet?
Rivulet,
yeah, creek and stream are kind of, you know.
Like, yeah. Depending on what part of the country you're
in. Right.
Right.
Then there's crick, right?
Right.
You know,
yeah.
Down by the crick.
Yes.
A dribble. There you go.
A dribble! Someone left the hose running.
Right. It's a runoff.
Cake out in the rain.
I never have that recipe anymore. All right, so. anyway. So you board a train in Alexandria. It takes you the 150 miles south along the French-built railway that borders the Nile River into Cairo. So, there we go.
Oh, cool.
Uh-huh. So, let's see here. You debark at Central Station, which is a few, about a half a mile northeast of where you need to go.
Okay. You can go for a stroll.
Yes, indeed. Yeah. So,
perfect walking weather.
Mm-hmm. As you were expecting. The city is a jostling bustle of people from all over Europe and the Near East and Africa rubbing shoulders. You hear any one of a half a dozen different languages being spoken. There are
open air markets along the way.
Yeah. There are motor vehicles contending with camels and mules for space on the streets. Well, let's see. Okay, so our two military types. You guys are in full uniform?
Yep.
Yeah, sure.
All right.
We're not the only ones.
And you weren't the only ones, yeah. Exactly.
Not to mention the fact, I mean,
I mean, right. I might be the only one wearing my uniform, but...
Right.
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 Particular uniform.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Only one with a fez.
No.
Right.
No.
Well,
no.
Not for long.
Well, no.
Okay, so the ubiquitous beggars of yeah. Cairo streets
yep.
Give you guys a bit of a berth.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Yeah.
Why? Well, because they have the uniforms.
Well, you presumably have guns at least in holsters, if not rifles over your shoulders, right?
True.
Rifle slung.
Yeah. but nonetheless, you feel the press of people upon you, mm-hmm. and... you immediately get the sensation that this is the sort of city where anything might be available if you ask the right person and are willing to pay the right price.
Okay.
How convenient.
Yes. So, you make your way down a grand boulevard running southwest towards the Nile. And catch sight of the Antiquities Museum, actually.
All right.
Before you reach your hotel. It's a stately pile. It's actually got a let's see. Okay. Its walls are sort of orange pink.
Lovely.
Orange pink.
Orange pink. Huh. And it has a large ornamental pool outside its white entrance portico tower upon which float rather large mauve colored flowers with golden centers.
Lovely.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Anyone has biology? Can anyone
nope.
1%.
I don't know, any kind of like natural history or.
I wonder if I have that.
Natural history.
Well, that's a 20.
Yeah,
so.
A little bit.
Yeah.
No.
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 Oh, mine.
Yeah.
Oh,
that's a 99. Yeah.
That's a flower?
You're quite certain those are fake.
exactly.
There's no flower that looks like that.
Right. Those are plastic?
Mm-hmm.
Shoddy done.
Shoddy. Yeah. Shoddy, yes.
Obviously, the person who made them should have kept a little bit more realism.
Yeah,
if they wanted people to think that they were, yeah, alive.
Yeah.
Yeah. What sort of place is this?
Okay, so, a couple blocks further south, you spot your Semiramis Hotel. And it is right on the Nile, kind of a, you know, North African style influenced architecture, but it's about 4-story high, taking up, you know, a whole city block kind
wow.
of grand hotel.
Lovely.
Yep. The gentleman at the front desk looks at the two soldiers a bit skeptically as you walk in.
Huh.
But as soon as the proper introduction is made that was supplied to you back in London, he immediately becomes about 10 degrees more obsequious and quickly gets you all checked in.
Good. Oh, we don't get to know what the secret code was?
you just say, Alex sent me.
Oh, okay.
Yes. So.
Oh, great.
Mm-hmm. So, basically you guys are established in Cairo. Where to? It's about 11 o'clock in the morning.
No, I was going to say, what are our suites like, though? Are they all, like, adjoining?
Actually, yeah, you have two suites adjoining. Helga and Dr. Fountain are sharing one. They have, each suite has two separate bedrooms opposite a common room or a common area.
Mm-hmm.
And then Captain Brett's and Private Bucket here in the other one.
Sounds about right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You have a nice balcony veranda on your suites looking out over the Nile,
mm-hmm.
Across from which is the extensive grounds of the Gezira Sporting Club.
Mm. Lovely.
Mm-hmm. And,
All right.
Well, I guess our first step is probably going to the museum, or would it be trying to look at this major...
Aloysius Blood Manders.
Yeah.
I bet I could go into the Sporting Club and take a look, see for
us. Yes!
He's a major.
That's true.
That's where he'd be hanging out.
Maybe. That's where I'm about to be hanging out.
Yeah. Helga and I can go to the museum.
I'd love that.
Yeah.
I do have like. No, I've got 26 in library use now, though, so I'm sure I'd be so useful in this.
How conservatively do I need to be dressed, by the way? Does it matter?
You know...
My head covered and all that?
No, so. It doesn't. Not in Cairo, at least.
Okay.
Yeah. Cool.
Mm-hmm.
Like headscarf tops.
Yeah.
Yeah, or a hat. Yes. Even just a hat.
Even a hat? Okay.
You'd have that anyway.
I'll just, yeah.
Exactly.
My usual hat.
Mm-hmm. Neat.
Keep the sun off.
Yeah.
Now, there's parts of Cairo you don't want to go into.
Yeah, without... it's like any metropolitan city.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
A male escort.
Yeah, or, well,
or, gun.
Or without your
permission. A trustworthy escort of anything, you know, some variety.
I think Helga can take care of herself. Mm-hmm.
Well, exactly. But do you want to have to? Do you want to have to be forced
to that situation? No, Helga, you brick husband.
Yes! Oh, I get it. Yeah. Oh, that's it. I'm writing that down.
New nickname.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yay. So we're going?
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah,
right.
Okay.
Let's say, so where's Charles going? Because you're not actually allowed in the Kasir Sporting Club.
Yeah, I know.
There's kind of like a reserved area for non-officers to just hang out and wait.
Mm-hmm.
That's about it.
Yeah, I don't really feel like waiting. I'll just... go with Professor and Helga to the museum.
Sure.
I've got a 27 in library use, so maybe that one.
It's
going to
be nice and cool in the basement.
Yeah, that's true.
Better bring a scarf on.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
One
low.
Yeah.
All right. So, you all head down to the exit from the hotel, give each other quick nods, and disperse.
Oof.
Okay, so the sporting club is accessible via a bridge spanning the river. So Brett's, you walk across and check in at the sort of, you know, gatehouse that's there, and are admitted straight away. So you have a variety of amenities you can avail yourself of. Mm. There's, you know, a tea room, there's polo grounds, there's a 12-hole golf course.
Wow. Whoa!
You know, so.
Winning is good.
I think perhaps grabbing a drink, and just meandering the grounds.
Sure.
Looking casual. Because I do want to try and see if this Major Blythe Manders is...
Mm-hmm.
Known.
All right, give me a luck roll.
I don't think I crush it, but...
Still me.
Yes.
All right.
Handle it.
So you stroll the grounds for a good, you know, 20 minutes or so and recognize one of your fellow Royal Engineers.
Oh, wow.
You don't know him, but, you know, he recognizes...
I know the type.
Well, he recognizes his service badge, so...
Hello! Good afternoon!
Ah, and you see his eyes flick to your, you know, your badge. He's like, ah! Hey, how are you doing, mate?
Excellent. Just arrived.
Gives you the Royal Engineer's secret handshake.
It's been a long time.
Wiggly fingers. Yeah. Don't forget the wiggly
fingers. It's been a long time engineering that.
Oh, shit. Wow.
Nice.
Oh. Nice. Okay.
just got into town. Thought I'd have a look around the club and... none.
Is that a Kiwi accent I detect?
In fact, it is.
Nice. You come all the way.
Oh, well, stationed out of London for a little while.
Of course. Well, I think you'll find Cairo is pretty different from London. No blackouts here.
Excellent.
No rationing at all, really. It's actually pretty sweet post.
Excellent. Of course. Where are you stationed from?
Oh, you know, I hail from that part of the UK that has a vaguely American accent.
I'm
Canadian.
Yeah, there you go. Perfect.
Yeah.
And how long have you been in Cairo for?
Oh, just since the war started.
Mm.
Sent me and my unit out here. kind of have fuck all to do. But, yeah, that's fine by me, I suppose. Not a whole lot going on in general.
Really, no.
You know. Yeah, I don't know. It's it is pretty nice out here, though. Might come back here when I retire.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
Oh, yes, of course. I'm Major Lawrence Henderson.
It's nice to meet you, Captain Sterling Britz.
Yeah, very good, very good. He proffers you a cigarette.
Thank you, thank you. So you say there's nothing to do in Cairo at all?
Oh, I didn't say that.
Well,
plenty of action if you know where to look.
Oh, God. Anything interesting going on then?
Anything interesting? Well, you know, there's some fine clubs. A little bit of a red light district, if that catches your fancy. Mm. I don't see a ring on your finger, even if I did. It doesn't matter to a lot of my mates. Yeah, otherwise, can't complain.
So, actually, I don't know if you're familiar with too many people around these parts yet, but I was looking for an old friend of my father's, Major Blythe Manders, as it happens.
Blythe Manders, seems to have a familiar ring about it. Yes. I think he's retired, if I'm thinking of the right guy. But I met him. He comes around here every once in a while. And, yeah, he lives here. He's actually the one who got me thinking about retiring here. Yeah, but a bit of an antiquities collector.
Is he now?
Indeed.
I do love me some antiquities.
Let's head into the clubhouse. We might have his address in the registry.
Oh, I'd be so grateful.
All right. So, meanwhile, our trio walks the couple blocks up to the Cairo Museum, as it's commonly called. And, let's see. Alright, so you walk past the strange colored flowers and under the white
flowers.
Portico tower.
It's nice they make an effort.
Yeah. Well, it's festive.
It's festive, yes. Yeah, add some color to the landscape.
It's a good sign that whoever makes these flowers is, you know, a good enough business that, you know, yeah. Sort of everywhere.
Yeah.
So you head into the courtyard of the museum.
Was there a fee to get in?
No.
Oh, nice. Okay. Back before that nonsense.
Well, of course, you haven't actually gone in the museum yet. You're just in the courtyard.
Ah, okay. All right.
You haven't been there long when a tall, well-built, immaculately dressed gentleman of somewhat olive complexion, thick black hair, slick back, and dark eyelashes.
How magnificent is his mustache? How magnificent is his mustache?
Oh, it's just a little pencil mustache. Approaches
pretty
you.
Magnificently.
Flutter?
Yeah.
Oh, yes. I mean, App 75, so...
Yeah. Wow.
Approaches you, addresses Dr. Fountain first as the eldest member of the group.
Okay.
Let me see here. Yes, hello.
Greetings.
May I help you?
As we've come to see the antiquities contained within your beautiful museum.
But of course, forgive me, but this is not a public museum. Do you have a letter of introduction? I am Lucien Couté. I am a linguist and Egyptologist in an employ of the museum.
I'm Dr. Wilberforce Fountain of Miskatonic University in Vermont.
Ah, Doctor, very nice to meet you.
This is my research assistant, Helga Hausen?
Yes, doctor. And I have the letter here somewhere. Just one second. Rifle through my bag. We have so many papers.
And he nods to Charles as well.
Yeah, Charles is there.
Terrible.
He's there.
Terrible, this time of war we are in.
Yeah.
Can we get a psychology roll?
Alright. P.
Yeah. It's only four columns of skills, man. Yeah. Come on. 8 point type.
Nope.
Alright.
Nope.
No. My psychology is at base, which means it's at five.
Okay. Right. You can the other two of you can give me rolls.
Oh, okay.
Oh, I'm in.
Oh, you did? Okay. Yeah. Yep.
You detect a slight frostiness in the way he's looking at Charles.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's because I'm a soldier, or is it because I'm black?
Don't be your eternal burden.
Yeah.
You'll never know.
Well, the uniform comes off.
Yeah, well.
We don't know. He's here to help us navigate the streets.
Yeah.
And the dangers that you would find in such a cosmopolitan city as Cairo. I am from a very small town.
I perfectly understand that Cairo is a city totally of its own.
It's of great sophistication. We need a little bit of help getting around.
Yeah. But of course.
I'm so sorry, I can't find the letter. I'm sorry, doctor, and then...
Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
You've done it again, Helga. Come all this way. What did you do with the letter?
Give me a fast talk roll.
Okay.
Oh, dear.
What if you drop?
Let's see.
Alex's name.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I absolutely made it.
Shot six.
Wow. Check your fast talk.
Woohoo. Okay. The water works, though.
Right. Yeah. He says, oh, please. Madame, do not cry. It is okay. There is no need for tears. This is just a museum.
Oh, thank you, sir. Doctor, it won't happen again.
I'm sorry, I'm imagining you like smacking her at the book to punish her.
Like the skipper in Gilligan, you know.
Yeah. And I'm like twice as big.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what makes it funny. It's like
a little
cat. Yeah. Like a little chihuahua.
Right. Yeah, okay.
We enter and view the wonderful...
He says, yes, of course, of course. Please follow me.
Sorry.
All right, so he takes you inside. All right. Once inside, he introduces you to his administrative assistant, Micheline Descoteau. She is blonde with skin bronzed by the Egyptian sun. Also quite attractive, a real attractive pair, these two.
Mm-hmm.
And basically asks what brings you to the museum.
Well, it's Cairo.
Yes, right.
Go to Cairo Museum in Cairo.
We're here to study specifically some of the... What?
Spot hidden rolls from everyone, by the
way. Whoa! Unexpected.
Yes.
Oh, I made it.
Oh, so do I.
Yes.
Chucky bucket.
Nope.
You're still fuming because he doesn't like you.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Blind. Well, I don't know anything.
You didn't notice, though.
No. No, I think I'm just ogling his assistant.
Right. Yeah.
Yes. Sir App. App 80.
Whoa.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Yep.
Uh-huh. Definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's your app?
50.
Oh.
Yeah. Not terrible.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'll go with your app.
Oh.
35.
Is it maybe just that your size is off-putting?
Maybe. And I'm punchy. Punchy is my distinctive feature.
Oh, that's right. Apple-shaped, we decided.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so...
A lot of belted jackets for you, then.
That's right.
There you go. Well, it's a good time for that.
Yeah. It is. He's managed to look smart in uniform.
Respect.
Yeah. But that size, though, I'm sure is like...
Whoa!
Amazon.
Yeah.
All right, so the two of you noticed that Micheline She's kind of behind a desk, you know, like a front desk. But she has a box in front of her that she was kind of sorting through when you walked in, and it's filled with index cards.
Hmm.
And the label on the box says archival records.
Ooh.
Hmm. So there's a box, index cards, and then she's got a journal next to her. She's obviously doing some kind of cross-indexing or cataloging of the contents of the box.
How close is the box to the edge of the desk? Just wondering.
Like, if you picture...
Yes, shenanigans!
If you picture a you know, table-height desk, and then there's a bank, you know, facing you, and then, like, another level there.
Oh.
That kind of thing. So, the box. So you would have to, like, reassemble it down.
Oh, it's like,
down,
it's just, like, bonded and have it. Right. Okay.
No.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, interesting. Lucian, we're here to see if you perhaps have any materials we might begin our research. I don't know where it's going to lead. You know how research goes.
Mm-hmm.
We'd like to begin perhaps with some material you might have on Akhenaten, his Amarna materials.
Yes, of course. Mademoiselle Descoteaux and I are currently engaged in a rather large project. The head of the museum, Abbé Drioton, he is a good man, but he is not up to the task required. We are attempting to write a visitor's guide.
Oh, that is a splendid idea.
And to figure out just what the museum does and does not have in its possession. So I say all that to say that any information I give you may be incomplete.
Ah. No. All right. Well, I will take it in with that framework.
Yeah, of course. I can. Let's see here. Micheline, and he says something to her in French, and she nods and stands up and actually picks the box up and slides it across to you.
What?
Oh, great.
He says, I believe this box actually has some material from Amarna in it. We will leave you to it if you wish. It is about time for our lunch break, I think.
So they're just going to leave us alone in this place?
Uh-huh.
Yes!
So yeah, I guess I'll hurry over to take the box from Micheline and just give her sort of thank you.
Go and give me an app roll. Let's see how this goes.
Oh, no.
That was an enthusiastic app roll.
What's going off the table?
Yeah, I make it 32.
Yeah.
All right.
Managed to smell charming.
Yeah, you managed to make eye contact, you know.
I'm one of the only people not sweating like crazy.
That's right.
I bet you have magnificent teeth.
Oh, yeah, I bet.
So white.
Mm-hmm.
So.
A winning smile.
Yes.
Indeed.
You going to try and go to lunch with them?
No.
All right, okay.
Yeah,
just establishing.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, all right.
Eye contact.
Eye contact.
Yeah.
She has to come back. She works here.
True enough.
That is true. All right. So, very good. So, it is, as you predicted, cooler within the depths of the library, the museum. And, you can just hang out at the desk and start going through the cards, if you'd like.
Go ahead and do that. I want to hot foot into the basement before they get back.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll go with you down there just to, you know.
There's snakes or something.
It's dark down there.
Yeah, I need your help.
Exactly.
And what language are the cards written in?
The cards are written in a mishmash. English,
sure.
French.
Yeah, perfect.
Okay, so Helga, give me a library use roll.
Okay. Do you want to come with Helga? Do you think you can do this quickly?
Let's see. I fail.
Here.
I can't make anything of this.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Okay.
Well.
Do you need help?
I guess so, yeah.
Something happens. I missed it by 1 point.
No!
One point. Yes. I rolled an 81.
Thanks.
Yes.
Thank you.
That is a perfect use for luck.
Yes, it is.
Oh, all right. So, yeah, you're like, you know, you spend 15 minutes. You don't want to spend too much time.
No, we have to put it to the basement.
Right. But you're just like,
what is this?
And you do see some stuff, Amarna. Yeah, okay, whatever. And you're basically done. And you're putting the box back, and your finger is like on one of the cards, and as you lift your hand away, it pulls the card up.
Yep.
You know?
Yeah, that happens all the time.
And your eye falls on the word black stuff. Black Steely.
Yes!
Oh, perfect.
Look!
Yeah.
So it says polished black Steely, age unknown, dynasty.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Recovered Sais, circa 1905. D-O-G.
Oh my god. This is it.
Yeah.
It's here.
It does say condition damaged.
It's okay. It's alright. We'll be able to come.
Yeah, yeah.
Location XXVI lowercase a 13 lowercase j lowercase b.
We gotcha.
Okay, so it's stored away in a box.
Decimal system.
Yeah, that's it. That's
yeah, yeah,
session
okay.
Number, and we are headed into the basement.
Okay.
All right. Yeah. Meanwhile, back at the sporting club.
Mm-hmm. Sound of violins and the wafting of palms.
Drinking a gin, Ricky.
Yay!
Indeed you are, and Major Henderson returns after a brief consultation with the head desk and says that he has indeed located the address for Major Aloysius Blythe Manders.
Woo-hoo! I would love to pay him a visit.
Great. He lives in the Saida Zainab district.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure at the front desk they can point me in that general direction.
Uh-huh. And yeah, they have a street number. Uh-huh. All right. So meanwhile, back at the museum.
Okay.
Not much else to say.
All right. Very well.
Can you imagine if we didn't have an officer? Like, if we bump into him at a cafe. That man looks like he could be a major.
Never gonna.
Never gonna happen.
You think so?
Yeah,
because we're so good. Yeah. Yeah, we just imagined it's
yep. Anything is possible. It's good.
All right. So. You have this index card.
We have the index card. Are you leading the way?
I think you would be leading the way. You know your way around a museum.
All right. Well, just thought it might be dangerous. Maybe you should go first.
Well, okay. I can walk. I can walk in front if you walk right behind me and tell me what turns to make.
Wait, it might be dangerous. You go first.
That's exactly what
it is. All right. If you insist, I'll walk in front of you. But I'm gonna take some wrong turns.
All right. That's no, okay. Let's go. That's fine. We're going. Okay. We're going in a big clump.
Yeah. Yeah.
It is indeed dark down here in these archives. Basically, the light is such as it is provided by some like glass brick lattice. Oh, you know.
Yeah.
Skylights in the ceiling.
All right.
Okay. Row 26, right?
That would be the assumption.
Yep.
All right. So you look for row 26, and actually, they're not so much rows as they are rooms.
Rooms.
Wow. Yeah.
But you do find a room labeled XXVI.
Right.
The door is locked.
Son of a. Well, lock picking. There you go.
Did I?
I thought about it.
I remember thinking about it.
Yeah, I remember talking about it.
I think Brett's just used the crowbar in the past instances.
I can engineer this off.
That's right.
Actually, I think what it was is I think Lizzie has locksmithing.
She does.
Yeah. So I think she was our other lock picker.
Let's see.
Well, I mean, how solid does the door look?
Right.
Let's see here. It is a wooden door, so you can try and force it.
It's like wooden yeah. office door.
Oh, you like shoot the door out?
No, just allow. Let's see if we can just kick it open.
That doesn't really work, does it? What? Just shooting the door if it's locked?
I don't know.
No idea.
It's one of those ones that might just be a Hollywoodism.
Yeah. I think it is.
Yeah. You just make the door angrier.
Yeah, yeah.
Just piss it off. No, it's really not going to open.
Like your bullet lodges in the door. It's still locked. All right, so yeah, I'm gonna try to kick open the door.
Okay. What's your strength?
50.
Right, we'll do an opposed roll. I'll roll against the door's strength.
Okay.
I got an 02.
Oh god, I got a 95.
Oh!
Ouch!
Oh
first
my god!
Oh my god!
That's like an actual play of Master of the Arthur that I listened to, where like each one of the players took it in turn to try and force a door, and each one fumbled, so they basically ended up causing themselves like serious like hospital
injuries. I'm just imagining
them
all running and knocking themselves out.
Yeah, basically yeah. just like, oh my shoulder.
Stand aside.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
All right. Well, this is. This museum was built in 1856.
Right. These are not
modern office doors. These are solid, you know, teak doors.
I'm gonna walk this off real fast.
Okay. Alright, I'll try. I'm gonna run upstairs
for a key.
Okay.
You can do that.
While you're doing that, I'm gonna run.
Okay.
They're eating, we gotta hurry.
Yeah.
Sure.
So I'm gonna try to.
They're French, they're gonna take at least 2 hours.
They know, right? What am I thinking?
They're French in Cairo. It's
going
to be at least 3 hours.
They're done. Yeah.
God, did you see how attractive they are?
I know! Please!
Like please.
We have to sit around and look ridiculously good for at least 4 hours. Alright, so Helmut, because of your size, it's still going to be a strength roll, but I'll say because of your size, you can roll a bonus die.
Okay.
So.
Bonus die.
Awesome. Oh, thank you.
Mm-hmm. She's mighty, mighty.
She's letting it all hang out.
That's it.
So, my strength is only 35.
Okay.
All right.
And then you do a 40.
Yeah.
So you can burn 5 luck to potentially succeed.
Yeah.
If you wanted to. Yeah.
Thanks. I keep forgetting.
Oh,
no. Right in that horrible moment, he reminds me.
Yeah. Luck. we have that. Mister. Yeah.
All right.
So, okay. I'm going to use 5 points
mark
of
off
luck.
5 luck. And, okay.
Let's see.
All right,
yeah.
Do I see anything? I run up to the desk in that area I'm looking for anything.
No key.
Sucker boot!
Back down.
Okay.
And by the time you get back down, Helga has forced the door.
Yay!
Oh, Helga.
So yay. Another good sign. You didn't hear us force the door.
Nope.
No.
Certainly did not.
No.
So I didn't hear squat.
No. Oh, great.
Yeah, I missed the door's strength by 1 point. So It was actually... Charles loosened it up for you.
Oh, that's all right. Thanks.
All right.
Yeah.
As I limp back up the hall towards you.
Yeah. Oh, that's smart.
Silently nod.
All right, we're inside. What did we see?
Okay. So, inside the room is lit by another skylight.
Mm-hmm.
And, let's see here. All right. So here the room has a bunch of rows.
Rows. Okay, now we have rows.
Yeah. Right.
And they're lettered, it looks like?
You see letters.
Okay.
Letters followed by numbers or just letters?
Just letters.
Okay, so row
A.
Yeah.
Okay. Very good.
There we go.
So you go to A. You see the individual stacks are numbered at the top of each
we
one.
Go to 13.
Okay, very good. And in 13, there are a variety of items on different shelves, but down at on the ground level, there's a large crate, and it just says, JB.
Alright.
And the crate.
The crate.
Okay, so can we open... Is the crate openable? Just at the top?
The crate, let's see here. The crate is nailed shut. If only Brett was here with his crowbar.
Yay!
Well, gosh.
Alright, I'm gonna take off my shoe and I will attempt to use the lip of my shoe.
Oh.
The sole.
Yeah.
And wedge it in there.
Oh, yeah. clever. Let's see here. Judicious use. Okay. It takes you a little while, but you can do it.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
Say, how tough are your shoes?
These are good Vermont shoes, Lee.
they're like horse shoes. Yeah,
solid Republican shoes.
Solid Protestant shoes.
Protestant shoes!
Yeah.
That's it. You got me. That's what I was looking for.
These shoes are made by Ethan Allen himself.
Exactly. God bless these shoes.
All right. That's what shoes, they're clogs. Alright, so... Alright, so you get the thing open. It is packed with packing straw, of course.
Excelsior.
Yep.
Yeah.
And within you find, wrapped in burlap, two lumps of black granite.
Great.
Two lumps of black granite.
Mm-hmm.
Well...
And do they have any writing on them?
They certainly do.
Well, I should hope so.
So, did it look like they were at one point like one piece?
Yes.
And broken in half? Okay.
Here comes Moses with the tablets.
So,
I just thought you had as curious.
Yes.
How big are these?
Of course. let's see. What's out of the box? Okay, they're like, individually, they're...
Is this? Are they like
this? No, bigger than that.
It's all Stila, so it's,
yeah,
it's quite large.
Like,
well, it's
each one's about probably 75 pounds.
Whoa.
Each one?
Mm-hmm.
So we can't just sneak it in our pocket.
No!
But we can take a rubbing.
Yeah. All right.
We can take a fresh rubbing.
Did any of you happen to see a dolly anywhere?
No.
Wouldn't that be cool? Yeah. Keep checking the rooms until you find the janitorial closet?
Well, this embodied head is not there, so... None of it occurs to me for that.
No, it doesn't.
Okay, so...
So...
Let's rub in.
Well, we also don't want the germs to find this, right?
It's a good point.
Yeah, that's true.
Are there other crates in this room?
Oh, I love it! What a great idea!
Absolutely. So, can I take the doctor or the professor's shoe and open up another one of the crates? And
switcheroo? Switcheroo? Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay.
Brilliant.
Yep.
I'm putting their accounting system back.
Yeah.
You're really never gonna.
Great job, ass.
Yeah, I know, right?
Someone
yeah.
Their job
takes the DVD and doesn't put it in its own case, but the next DVD's case.
Yeah.
My brother's
me.
Yeah. Oh yeah, my brother used to do that. I remember.
No, I do that.
Drove my mom crazy. You, yeah.
I admit to it. I do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's me.
Oh, you do that too?
Oh yeah.
We're
yeah.
Evil. We're just evil.
It's just me. So I'm like, well,
right.
What was the movie I watched before this one?
Yeah.
Okay, so with that done,
yes.
After we do the rubbings and. Yeah, with that done,
okay.
Nail back the crates.
Yeah.
Take that old shoe, nail it back in.
Well, I'll just start with the shoe, and then I can use the butt of my rifle to do the rest of them.
Uh-huh. Right. Ah. Put another box on top to make some extra.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Dust.
Just
on there.
Yeah, sprinkle a little dust over the top of it and make sure.
Oh man.
I don't know. Is that safe enough? I'm wondering.
Well, it's not like we can go out with these, but we can remember at least where we put them, and
yeah.
That perhaps we can come.
Could we move them just to an entirely different room? I would imagine that the Nazis would come in with
them?
A team and like open everything if
we
they couldn't
take
them.
Whole fucking museum.
Yeah,
we should destroy them. But there's nothing we can do.
Burn the museum down.
Yeah, well, I mean they're granite, so
no.
Yeah,
we could sink them in the Nile, but. I mean, I didn't say that. I'm making a future scientist so mad.
It's like 75 pounds each. Like, how far do you have to, like, take it out on a little boat?
Yeah, you're right.
Like,
no, it's outrageous. We can't. The hiding it in the stacks
are
is good.
All right. Okay.
We should hide it.
Well, you are only about 2 blocks from the river.
No, it's not. What if we need it again for some crazy reason?
I don't know.
What if we screw up or we lose the rubbing?
Oh, yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So at least we know where it is now.
We know where it is. Nobody else does.
Exactly.
But you want to take it across the hall or something, right?
Yeah, in a different room.
What do you think?
Let's take it to,
I'm not that strong, so I'm going
to... Let's take it to, like, 15 or something.
Yeah, let's go bananas.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're taking it to 15.
Yeah, we'll take it to 15.
So
15, and then
XVI.
Let's put it in.
XV, and then
row. Let's say E.
Well, let's go. Let's get there and see what's in there before we.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see what crates are in 15, room 15.
Okay, what's in room 15?
There are no crates. So.
Because obviously there's you know something written for every single room in that book right now.
This is just making me think of there's a Cthulhu scenario where like you play the local law enforcement and the bad guys are a team of investigators who come into town and start burning down your life.
Yes.
And you're like trying to stop them from like destroying your town, basically.
There's a whole book like that. I have to before I started gaming Cthulhu, there was a book that was about exactly that. It was really funny.
I think this worm is talking.
Rum is talking.
All right, so let's say 15E. Mm-hmm. I don't know, 10 JB. Okay. If that's what all of the bottom crates are called.
Okay.
Oh no!
Every crate has a different.
Okay.
Set of letters on it.
All right, so we'll just
then DC.
Let's just hide the
DC. I like it.
Yeah.
Let's make it DC. Okay.
So 15 E10 DC is where we're putting this.
Okay. So yes.
Give me an idea roll.
Two.
Whoa.
Oh, nice.
Strikes you like a thunderbolt. His jowls wobble. Yeah.
Like that.
Yes.
Let's see. So, yes, it occurs to you that the initials are probably Julius Bergdorf.
Oh, I never would have thought of that. Okay.
And then you look like, well,
it's his Bergdorf, of course. All right, that old fraud.
That old contemptible.
My disembodied head wonders if there's anything else that with those initials on it.
We'll never know. All right, who has the lowest luck?
Probably 59.
Ooh,
that's you.
I burned 5.
Okay, so what are you at?
I'm at 50 now.
All right, give me a little roll.
Okay,
80.
80, wow.
Nice. 79. Nice.
Oh, 45.
Woohoo!
Sweet. Yeah.
Alright, so you guys get back up top. Oh, actually, quick question. What's your combined strengths?
So I have 50.
35, that's 85.
50.
So 135. Alright. Someone give me a roll against that.
Against 135?
Yes.
56 out of 135.
56 out of 135, so that is less than half.
Yes, it's quite good.
And I rolled 35 against the 150 strength, which is more than 1/5.
Yeah.
So you're in the same bracket.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so you guys are able to slide it out and across.
Okay,
No, just 75 pounds?
Per each.
Well, it's 150.
Well, for the crate.
I mean, that's true. The crate.
Like the crate is like solid wood.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're not taking the crate. We're just taking the. Taking the individual.
Yeah.
The innards.
Oh.
Yeah. We're just taking the two pieces.
You're gonna leave the empty crate.
No, we're shell gaming it. So one's going in one.
Oh.
And then you'll take some pottery out of another crate or something.
Exactly.
And put it in there.
Yes.
Yes. We do.
Yes. And so we'll have to. So we're putting in 15 E10 DC, so we're going to have to take out the cards for 26A, 13 JB, and 15.
Yes, that's right.
So alter the cards?
Or just take them out altogether?
Just take them out.
Just remove them.
Yeah.
Just disappear them.
I love it.
Yeah, that way, you know, people don't know what's in one, and they won't be able to look back and see what's in the other.
Yeah.
Okay, I will need another library use roll, then, in that case. The toy.
Yes.
Great.
Awesome.
All right. Luckily for you, Micheline has cataloged room 15 already.
Oh, good.
And so you're able to find the appropriate card.
Lovely.
And remove it.
Great.
Okay. And sure enough, they have not returned from lunch yet.
No.
Yeah.
So. It's a lovely day. It's lovely.
Okay.
We have the rubbing Helga.
Yes.
Excellent.
We need time for the aperitif. Digestive.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All of the in between.
Nap.
All the wine.
The nap, exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it does actually. Yeah. Anyway, so yes, you do have the rubbing. And it is better than Ehrlichman's rubbing, as he himself predicted it would be. Mm-hmm. The blotches that appeared on the original rubbing are now much more clear. They are a strange spiral design.
Oh, I don't like that. Oh. Wait a minute, we've seen that before.
Have we?
We have. I have.
Do you see it every time you close your eyes?
Yeah.
I think also we need to find this major. Sun worshippers, right? Oh, I guess. What's that? I was saying, because weren't we told that Akhenaten's sun worshipping the disc cult had sort of a spiral design, yes, as their mark.
maybe they did
perhaps they
I didn't listen to everything from the beginning. It was kind of like flooded in.
It was a lot of material.
But I kind of remembered. I remembered that part. Yes. Pretty sure there was a spiral in there.
The other interesting thing that you observe in the course of studying the stone and doing the rubbing is that that design is carved, you know, all over the granite. Including like where the writing is, and yet it doesn't disrupt the writing.
Yeah, that's curious.
So it's almost like beneath the writing and yet over the writing at the same time.
Wow,
that's wrong.
Do we need a sand roll for that?
Yeah, exactly.
I think that would be appropriate. Yeah, go ahead.
This doesn't make any damn sense. The basic material level, it shouldn't be
80. So yeah, that's what?
One fail. That's a one
yeah.
Yeah. How the hell do you do that?
The 1 point. I think I lost another point too.
Yeah.
Ah, my brain.
As you swear or invoke a patron saint or whatever.
Yeah.
Say a little juju prayer.
Yeah.
All right.
So we emerge into the main floor?
Indeed you do. Yeah. It says here, virtually no one in the establishment works between 1 o'clock and 5:30 p.m.
Yes.
Wow.
What time is it now?
It's about 1 o'clock.
Yeah.
Oh, we have plenty of time.
I know, we do. We could look. We want to see stuff?
Yeah, let's explore a little bit. Right. Maybe.
Let's open some sarcophagus and see.
Oh, yeah.
You not be in the same room when they open a sarcophagus.
What do you have to for science?
Science,
yes.
You enjoy your curse. I'm going to be in the other room not enjoying curse.
Not enjoying the curse. What's Captain Brett's up to?
Well, I was going to take a stroll down the lane and see if I can find
the the house.
Yeah.
Fine. yeah, you've got a pretty good idea where that is. It's sort of in Old Cairo. Mm-hmm. So you very soon find yourself in one of those districts that Major Henderson darkly hinted at. you realize it's been a while since you've seen a non-Arab face. There's beggars periodically approaching you saying, "Bakshish, bakshish," holding out their hands.
Eyes ahead.
All right.
Nothing.
Yeah.
They seem upset that you're not giving them anything. You do presently.
Indeed. It means bad step, right? So in French, faux pas, literally.
Oh, yes. So. Bad step, yes.
Just thinking she was still on drink.
All right. Let's see. You're
armed, though, right?
Yeah.
And like,
yes, you are armed.
Visibly armed.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Should be okay.
Yeah.
Sure.
So you pass by, you know, large apartment complexes where people are just kind of hanging out on the verandas and watching you, you know, dispassionately as you walk by, you know. Your one saving grace is that you're still in an area of town that actually has street signs.
Excellent.
And eventually you find yourself outside of a large walled house complex that is the address that you were given.
Knock, knock.
Okay. Okay. Let's see. Okay. So, it is a latticed wooden gate set deep into a thick outer wall. Mm-hmm. Not so much a knock as it is a metal bell pull with a highly polished brass handle.
Lovely.
Mm-hmm. So you hear the bell ring within. A few minutes pass by, and the gate swings open. A tiny, gnarled man with coffee-colored skin mm-hmm. and radiantly blue eyes mm. is staring up at you. Mm-hmm. He kind of squints at you, like he's trying to figure out how to address you. Mm-hmm. And then says, "Yes," in English.
Apologize for the intrusion. I'm looking for a Major Blythe Manders.
Yes. So he just turns around and starts walking back.
I'm gonna follow him.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so he's kind of walking with a sort of swinging gait. You can hear him chuckling to himself. Mm-hmm. And he's sort of talking to himself in Arabic mm-hmm. under his breath. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay, so he leads you through a small garden, very nicely tended, mm-hmm. Rose bushes in full bloom, and mm-hmm. There's a carved lattice well in the middle with a stone cap on it.
Hmm.
You spot
that doesn't seem like just a little.
You spot what's that?
What lies beneath?
What lies beneath? Yes, yeah. Mm. It's very substantial.
Just saying, stone. If Rome has lizard people, what does this place have?
Yeah, little flashbacks.
Shake it off, shake it off.
You spot a little shrine over in the corners of the garden.
Mm-hmm.
And, and a camel can be heard from the street. Okay. So, he takes you into the building itself. The Salam Lik, which is the greeting area. And... Okay, so, you wait.
Hmm.
And, he hustles off, returns 5 minutes later, indicates you to follow him, takes you through a doorway, and you see a very paunchy-looking man, sort of laid out on a side couch, puffing away on his shisha pipe.
Mm-hmm.
And, he's kind of, he's got some florid, you know, touches to his cheeks and nose. His, formerly blonde hair turning white and thinning. Mm-hmm. But, a fine mustache graces his lip.
Mm.
And, wearing a well-tailored linen suit. With a silk cravat.
Yeah, that just looks so comfortable.
Mm. You also note that his shoes, although civilian, are polished to perfect, you know, barracks room inspection standards.
Interesting.
Man after man heart.
So he stands up and he says,
Sheikh Janine told me that a military man was here.
So he gives you a salute.
Salute back.
I am Major Aloysius Blythe Manders. Who are you, my dear boy?
I am Captain Sterling Bretz, British Army Engineer. I'm here visiting Cairo, of course, in this time of war.
Of course, of course. Please, have a seat.
Yes. Thank you.
So, there's a wicker chair next to his couch, you know. A young serving boy comes in with a sort of a tea service. There's some Turkish delight on a tray.
Ooh, yummy.
And and a, you know, a tall silver, you know, tea server, you know, with tiny cups.
Lovely.
Pours the tea out.
Oh, well, just making the rounds, or?
A bit of that, yes. I'm in town escorting, actually, more of a research team, as it were. I don't know if you're perhaps familiar with, but we're assisting the research of Botho Ehrlichman.
Botho Ehrlichman? Yes. Yes, of course. I, that is a familiar name. I haven't talked to him in quite some time. How is he doing?
Well, he's dead.
Well, he's dead.
Well, I, it's terrible. He wasn't that old, was he?
No, it was a tragic wilderness accident. Frozen to death.
Froze to death. Oh, so this was
September. August.
Start with World War II.
Well,
days.
Belgium, of course.
Belgium. No man. Okay.
But how?
It's not the strangest death, but comes close.
So you can see, of course, how his research needed to be taken up.
Yes, of course. Of course.
But of course, I am merely assisting, and as you inquired, yes, just making the rounds, but that's the long and short of it.
I see. Yes, the last communique I had with Herr Ehrlichman was about 12 months or so ago. He was writing me about a black stone.
You don't say.
Yes. Thought I might have had it in my possession. I'm a bit of a collector of antiquities, you see.
I heard, actually. Your name was certainly flourished amongst his notes as an appreciator of things fine and strange.
Yeah. Oh, good. Yes, the trash dealers learned long ago not to pay me any attention.
Oh, okay. I'm sure. I mean, it does take a discriminating eye, I'm sure.
Mm-hmm. Indeed it does. But I did not have that particular item.
Was it anything you'd heard of before?
Let's see. Let me search my memory. No, I can't say. I can't say I rang any bells, as they say.
Did he ever end up writing to you anything about Amarna or Aachen Aten?
No.
Oh, I'm just curious.
Yes, of course. Mm. Forgive me, I'm not quite as young as I used to be.
Oh, not at all.
He gets a fan out and starts fanning himself. It's much too hot today.
Isn't it? It's the worst stuff.
Well.
So, Mater, you'll have to tell me, how did you come yourself to end up in Cairo?
Well, I was stationed here back before the Great War, you know. Kind of fell in love with it. The antiquities and all that. Great place to make one's twilight years a little more interesting.
You don't say.
Would you like to see my collection?
No, I would love to.
Excellent. Alright, so back at the museum, what are you guys up to?
You guys are defiling.
We're leaving.
Yeah, we're leaving.
We have nothing else to do.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
We've got the rubbings. We can bring them back to the hotel. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right.
Let's go get a quinine water or something.
Yeah.
Coffee. Coffee's in order. Yeah.
Or the malaria.
Yeah.
All right. So. So the major takes you on a tour of his house. It's three stories, very well built.
Lovely.
Nice and cool, wow. And the interiors, you know. And yes, he does indeed have a very impressive collection, kind of artfully displayed throughout his house.
Wow.
You know, including a couple authentic sarcophagi.
Wow, we were supposed to
mostly Egyptian. Oh, yeah.
There's... The oldest items in his collection are, like, Middle Kingdom. Mm. But, like, the sarcophagi he has are from the Ptolemaic period. You But yeah, he has, you know, he has, you know, like grave goods and, you know, necklaces, jewelry, various swords. And, you know, as far as you're concerned, it all looks completely legit.
Sure. So. I don't know, does anything look familiar since we have to poke around the museum portion of that one Sphinx Club?
Yes.
Or, you know, poking around in Rome?
Make an archaeology roll.
No.
Nothing jumps out at you. But yeah, it takes you a good 45 minutes to go through.
I'm duly impressed.
And he says, "Well, if you don't mind, it's about that time of day for my lie down,
isn't it just?"
Yes. I say there, Janine, and the little wizened man. Janine, Sheikh Janine is my gardener, you see. He's, he came with property, as it were. Good man, though, good man. Please show Captain Brett's out. Give you another salute. And so the wizened little Sheikh leads you out through the garden and gets to the lattice gate, turns, and puts his arm out to open the gate for you, and his sleeve kind of falls back, and you see that he has a tattoo on his wrist. And it is a strange swirling pattern. There it is. But you get the feeling that he wanted you to see it. It's a very deliberate move, and he's looking at you while he does it.
I'm gonna give him a little nod as I leave.
You give him a nod. He does not open the gate.
What?
Uh-oh. It's a trap.
Is it?
Is it, though? No, instead...
It's something within human strength.
No, instead, his hand drops from the handle of the gate, and instead moves and takes your hand. Okay. And he says... he starts speaking to you in a mixture of Arabic, French, and English.
Of course.
But you're able to make out the meaning.
So was it like Cajun?
Which basically... Come on down now.
Shit.
Oh my god.
I'm
sorry. No, don't be sorry.
No, he says, come back with your friends. After dark. And bring with you the flowers of the blue lotus.
Flowers of the blue lotus. Hmm. We haven't seen any blue flowers.
No.
Just crazy pink ones.
And he communicates the bit about the lotus by drawing a stylized kind of Egyptian lotus in the dirt and pointing at his eyes.
Ah.
Blue lotus.
All right, and out again.
So now he opens the gate. Bows you out.
Big clue found.
All right.
Yep.
I'm probably going to be in a good mood and a little more free with my pennies and candy on the way back.
Yeah.
Pennies and candy.
Spilled a bunch of Turkish delight off the train.
No. You know, I'm an officer. I'm not poor.
That's right. Yeah, you draw a good salary. Okay, so... so you are, and you detect less hostile looks as you make your way out of the neighborhood.
That's good.
Leave the good impression, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
You're not a sucker. You should leave a good impression.
Okay, so you guys are back at the hotel.
Man, mission now, man, time to kill.
Right. So, presumably, you'll rendezvous at the hotel at some point in the afternoon.
Indeed.
We need to find Blue Lotus.
What now?
What?
Why?
Who with the what now?
All right, so then you fill us in?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah. Little man with blue eyes.
Yeah, no.
Yeah. All right, so we have to look for that.
Okay. Major Blythe Manders.
Well done.
Interesting.
Yes. Apparently he'd been in contact with Erlfman, who'd been looking to see if he might know the whereabouts or be in possession of the Black Stone. which he was not, but his gardener, a tiny, weazened Egyptian man, had a strange tattoo, which struck a bell with me. It was a sort of strange spiral.
Sort of like, this one?
As a matter of fact, and he indicated that I should come back with my friends after dark and bring flowers of the blue lotus.
Yeah.
What did you guys do?
We took those rubbings.
We found the stone.
Oh, you found the stone.
That's good.
Neat.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we gotta get the blue lotus, and we have to try and translate this.
And maybe we should also have lunch.
Let's eat something.
Yeah.
It's, we can eat some here now, don't we?
It's a bit past.
Yeah. I've only had Turkish delight.
Oh, God, no.
Well, and your gin reiki, so.
God, what a mess.
Yikes.
Nah, I have a little nosh at the club. But, okay. But.
Should we go down then? Should we go down to the...
Yes, the restaurant.
Yeah. Oh, sure.
If there is one,
I would imagine a hotel that consumes an entire block has its own restaurant.
Yeah. Or two.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. You,
Let's take the rubbers with us.
Yeah,
we're going to leave them in the room.
Oh,
yeah. Disastrous, Sonia. Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
So the hotel serves French cuisine. So you have a fine French style lunch.
Yay.
And full up on bread and cheese.
Yeah.
And wine.
Oh.
You are left to contemplate your next move. So what's your next move?
Find some blue lotuses.
We first need to find blue, and I want to look at this rubbing and see. I don't know, some kind of a flower, I would imagine.
Yeah.
We have to look at these rubbings and see if we can figure anything out from them.
Yeah, they may lead us to
something.
Yeah.
Mm. So, can we determine what language the rubbings are in?
Part of it is Atlantean.
It's a Rosetta Stone type.
Exactly. So you have seen the original rubbings. You're able to match it against the copy you have.
Right.
And basically, what you can determine with study is that the rubbings were more or less accurate. Mm-hmm. It's just that with the spiral design is the thing that you didn't have on the previous rubbings. Right.
What's the significance of the spiral design?
Yeah.
Is it tracing a...
And I can repeat that bit of
text.
Yes,
do.
Yeah,
that
was the sign of the Amarna ritual cult. Or not Amarna. But it was the ritual cult... Heretical monotheistic group of sun disk worshippers of Akhenaten.
Indeed. And the stone itself says, in the red and white land, the land of the black earth and the bountiful waters, they shall make a home, promising to remember the mistakes of the past, so that they might never repeat them. That which they carry with them, besides their thoughts and memories and fears, shall be guarded, protected, and nurtured, until such time as it is no longer safe to leave it be. And so they will seek to hide it, burying it deep in the hope that the light of darkness will never find it and bend its will to that of rigid order and insanity. At the rising of the sun on the horizon, there shall come a day which they should have foreseen, but have been blinded to in the surety of their faith and understanding. And there it lies in the maw of that most ancient enemy, born out of sleep's hollow nightmare and awaiting its revenge, ready for the taking, the light which cannot be.
So we're going to remember that, to ask the old guy and see if he knows what it's
about. But we're looking for a blue lotus.
Yeah.
So, flower shops?
Something. Or maybe I can, draw it from memory.
Mm.
I mean, I'm an engineer, so I can draw.
That's true. Yeah, give me an idea roll.
Yep.
Okay. Easily done.
All right, and I'm going to... show it to, waitstaff or something.
The front desk.
Yeah, concierge.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Concierge.
The friend at the front.
So he looks at it.
The easiest one.
And he says, that's a Egyptian design of some sort, I suppose.
Do you have any idea what kind of flower a lotus might be?
A lotus? That's some sort of oriental flower, I believe.
Are there any flower shops?
Oriental ones? Here? Specifically? Oh, exotic flower shops. Yes, yes. And he writes down some street directions.
Oh, great. Excellent.
All right. Lovely.
Yeah. Head on over.
Off we go.
Yeah.
What do we have for lunch, guys?
Cheese and bread.
And wine.
Mm. Ooh, dates. I love dates.
Oh, well then.
Have to in Egypt, yeah. Mm.
Yum.
All right, okay. So back to the markets. You follow the directions. You find this little hole-in-the-wall flower shop.
Right.
It has a lot of orchids and, you know, hothouse plants of all varieties. And it is run by a man of somewhat indeterminate ethnicity.
Hmm. So he's Turkish.
Can I help you?
Yeah. What happens? We are in the market for a particular flower, a blue lotus.
Blue lotus? Well, I don't have any of those. Those are rather large flowers.
Are they?
But you know, I think there are some that grow in the ornamental pond outside the Antiquities Museum.
Oh.
You might ask them where they got theirs.
Hmm.
Did we see that? They weren't the right color.
Yeah.
Let's go back.
Okay. Thank you. Thanks. Mm-hmm. Excellent. Mm.
Is there any way to potentially dye the petals of a flower?
I was thinking that too. Oh, yeah.
To your knowledge, being a flower vendor?
Oh, well, certainly, yes.
Just add it to
the water.
Yeah.
Yes. Oh, I see. Mm-hmm.
But the blue lotus, that's a naturally occurring flower. They're kind of mauve colored.
Oh.
Oh. Now that I know it's mauve, that's helpful.
That is helpful, yes.
Mm.
Maybe we were distracted by those fake flowers that they had.
Let's go look at them. Yeah.
So what is up with those fake flowers?
Roll 99, right? Yeah. How what flowers did you get?
I know!
those fake pink ones, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Lushness, like plastic.
What time is it?
Let's see, you had a late lunch. It's about 5 o'clock.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so someone might be back at the museum.
They might indeed.
Yeah, but we're not going in.
We're just going to hang around the front.
But weren't we going to ask them where they got their lotuses?
Oh, we were, you're right. I was presuming we'd be able to find it in the pond.
But he said that they have them in their ornamental pond.
He did say that.
And so we could probably just ask them where they got theirs. Yeah.
Well, let's.
All right.
First, let's find the flowers in the ornamental pond.
Yeah.
Maybe we won't have to ask anyone before we just take one.
Yeah. We said flowers. Plural.
I thought he just wanted one, the blue lotus.
Flowers of the blue lotus.
All right, so we'll take 3 or 4.
For each of us.
They're big.
How many do they have is the better question, because if we take all of them, I think they'll notice. But if we take one...
They might notice.
What color are they, though?
Well, they're like a mauve, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's the blue lotus, but what about the ones in the pond?
Well, let's find out.
Yes.
No, but that's what I'm saying, is what color are the ones in the pond?
Well, we're going right now.
And when we arrive,
you see
a pond full of mauve-colored flowers
with
golden centers.
Oh,
my. It's full of them!
Yeah!
Let's take a lot!
Yeah! Maybe let's ask.
Okay.
Okay, so it's October?
Yes.
Late October?
Yes.
So, what time is dark going to be today?
It's
starting to get dark. We'll be dark by 7-ish?
It's equinox. Equinox is, when is equinox? September?
Okay. Yeah, because winter solstice is in January, right?
December 22nd. Midsummer's July 20-something. So
halfway between July and December.
Yeah. So what I'm saying is the days and nights are about equal right now. About.
Isn't that the Halloween? Isn't Halloween something?
Oh yeah, I guess maybe. We're terrible.
Yeah.
Out of my mind.
The coffee hasn't kicked in.
That has kicked in.
Yeah. All right. So
anyway,
so it's getting darkish.
Yeah.
So we just have a couple of hours to kill that.
Hour and a half. Yeah.
So in New York, September 1939, sunset was at 6:43 p.m. I don't know what that would translate to.
But that's in New York.
Yeah. Just
So further south, the sun would set later.
Later.
Yeah. So yeah, 7:30. Yeah, so
okay.
Say 7:30.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
So, what's the plan?
Let's inquire. Just ask them.
Inquire.
Ask them for the flowers. And if they say no, where did
they're
you
gonna
get
know that we want the flowers.
Yeah. Well, like I said, I love those flowers. All right. Where did you get them? Is it possible? Can we take just a few? I know.
I'm going to grab one before we ask, just in case. Okay. Can I do that?
Yeah, you can
okay.
do that. All right, so as Helga hangs back, the three of you walk through the entrance okay. portico. You see Micheline making her way across the courtyard, studying something on her clipboard, but of course your entering draws her attention. Mm-hmm. She immediately looks at Charles.
Oh! I'm gonna elbow you because I have no tact.
Oh, so, bonjour.
Yes, good evening, Miss. Yes, good evening, Micheline. we were curious about the flowers in the ornamental garden, the mauve lotuses.
The lotuses. They have been there ever since I came here.
They're very beautiful.
Oh, I like to think so, yes.
Yeah, damn it.
She has blue eyes.
They remind me of the color of your eyes.
Oh, God!
This is painful.
Don't have very many social skills. I gotta roll for that guy.
Does he smile a little too late, but still charmingly, I wonder?
Yeah, exactly. Like, what are you doing, idiot?
I roll my eyes.
I was curious if I were to pick one and present it to you, would you accept it?
Oh!
There we go.
There, that's better.
Hold on to that tailspin right at the last moment. Alright. give me a your choice, fast talk or persuade.
Oh, remember what I was saying, I don't have very good
yeah.
other one.
Persuade because
you're
that's
burn some luck.
I don't know that much luck to burn, guys.
Oh, shit.
Oh!
That's an 80.
Okay.
Oh!
Ouch!
So she says, oh, well, they are very rare flowers. We cannot spare a single one, but that's very sweet of you.
Oh. Wow. Where do they come from?
I don't know.
Oh! Wow.
She's lying. Or dumb. I don't know.
Well, perhaps we can discuss some of the flowers in the garden at breakfast tomorrow.
Oh, monsieur. That is very forward of you. I accept.
Lucky
Chucky
Bucket. Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh, give me a spot hidden roll.
Oh my god. Oh, sure. Nope.
The rest of you can make it too. Well,
okay.
No, that's
I'm stealing flowers.
You're currently stealing
once
flowers.
Once again,
I failed.
Not enough luck.
I make it.
Yes! Woo-hoo!
So, Brett's probably because you're standing right next to Bucket, and this is the first time you've seen her. You note that. Her clothes, although nice, have been carefully patched. Her shoes are repaired several times.
Mm. Hard times.
How shiny are they?
As shiny as you can have old shoes be.
Mm.
She's trying.
Mm.
Yeah.
It's admirable.
Mm-hmm.
It's working.
Yeah.
She's pretty.
Yeah.
Aww.
So she takes a card from her. From her coat pocket, and she says, my other job is my family's antiquities store.
Oh.
You can come by and meet me there.
Ah, what time do people usually have breakfast in Cairo?
Oh, 9 o'clock.
Well, see you at 10 to 9. Nice cafe.
Alrighty. Good.
Yeah.
All right, so...
Yes!
Yay!
Meanwhile, Helga has stolen a blue lotus.
Yes.
Just one.
Just one. I don't want to risk it.
Okay, yeah. That precious.
No, they have very deep root systems down below.
Try
not to splash too much.
Yeah.
Smart thing to do.
Yeah.
Thanks.
All right. So.
I imagine you, like, all, like, sodden up to the elbow.
Right.
What happens if you think you like to wrap those roots in something?
Oh, yeah.
Not the rubbings, though.
Don't wrap them in the rubbings?
Don't do
no,
that.
Okay.
Okay, so, let's see.
I'll wrap them in my socks.
There you go. Oh, my God. There you go.
Yeah.
No,
so,
my
we're going to start making our way back to the Saidas and... No.
District.
Yes, you are. Okay. So, you start heading back. The sun is beginning to make its descent.
Is it neon? Yes. Is it neon?
Yes.
Yeah, good thing we have you with us.
Indeed. Yeah, you feel some eyes on you as you make your way down these narrow streets.
Mm-hmm. Constant vigilance!
But you arrive at the latticed gate outside the Blythe Mander's house.
Is it after dark?
It's twilight at this point.
You said after dark.
We can have a cigarette, wait around.
One around the block?
Yeah.
I don't know. Is it like a residential district? Is it like a...
It's like kind of like a working class neighborhood.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So there's like coffee houses and stuff. You can go...
Yeah, we can...
Let's kill like 20 minutes.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay. We want to follow the letter of what he said.
Okay. Yeah. A weasened old man like that, you don't take his word lightly.
All right.
Especially when he struggled to get that much English out.
All right. Who's got the lotus?
I've got it. Yep. Okay. It's in my hat, I guess.
Like
in your hat?
I don't know.
Like, I love it.
Like inside? Like sitting on top of your head?
No, no, no. Okay. Not visible.
In the dome of your hat.
Yeah. Yeah.
I love it.
It's fantastic.
It's on my lapel.
You're just wearing it. Oh, look.
Spray it out. It's like, it's huge.
No, yeah, it's just too tacky.
Right.
Too tacky. Do you feel it? Does it feel weird on your head? You alright there?
It's dripping.
It just drips a little bit, yeah.
It's okay. It's a good thing it's so hot.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
All right. So, twilight turns to dusk. And you go knock on, or you ring the bell on the lattice gate.
Okay.
So, the gate opens almost immediately.
Janine.
He nods to you, then nods to the other three of you, appearing to be not the least bit surprised that you came back.
There's more of us.
Well, when you're that old, you're not surprised by anything.
It's a hat.
Okay. Ah! So I doff my hat.
Ah! That's good stuff.
So
he reaches in, pulls the lotus out, and then puts his finger to his lips and ushers you all in.
Yeah.
God.
Okay.
Splash.
It's a little damp up there.
Yeah.
Oh,
gosh.
All right. So. Alright, so you walk into the courtyard, and let's see, dusk is rapidly gathering, and the moon is already out. Let's see, you can hear a sound of snoring echoing from within the house.
Excellent. His mustaches trembling
in his life. And, let's see. Alright, so, the Sheikh leads you over to the well.
Of course.
And, begins struggling to get the stone lid off.
I'm gonna assist him.
Okay. Where's that chirping coming from? Oh, it's the birds outside.
Yes.
Oh, okay. I forgot I opened the window. I'm like, it's not so realistic.
I mean, you managed to even yourself become lost in the narrative. So I'm helping him with the stone wood.
Yes.
All right. Let's see here.
Wait, there's a lid over the top of the well.
Yes. It's covered well. That's how your children don't fall in. It's typical. Also, your water doesn't evaporate, and sand doesn't get in.
You don't want any of those things.
Being from a place that would have similar wells, I don't imagine that the lids on them would be quite so heavy.
No.
So...
This is Cairo. Look at the stonework of the house. It's all very old.
Uh-huh. Yeah. going to...
The last time we went into a subterranean sewer system, everything turned out fine.
That's not what I heard.
What? Oh, that's right. You weren't there. No, it was fine.
He was busy being tortured.
We had a better time than you did.
So, ouch! Going to step back slightly. Not take more than like a half step back, but I will, you know, sort of loosen the hand or the holster that has my hand sidearm in it.
Yes.
And prepare for something terrible to come out.
That's very smart.
Okay. All right, so Brett and Shake muscle the lid off the well. It moves slowly with a rasping sound across the stone lip, and then kind of slides down off to the side.
That was perfect. Yep. You hear a slithering sound from the bowels of the earth.
So, Brett, you are looking down into a well. Mm-hmm. There is calm, dark waters, only about a foot below the edge of the well.
Mm-hmm.
Or edge of the... not the edge of the well, the...
the lip?
What?
No, no, no. The ground level. So, you're looking down into the well, there's water a little further down, about a foot below where your feet are.
Okay. And it's still...
And it's perfectly still. Uh-huh. You can see your reflection with the moon behind you, you know, like a mirror, basically.
Hmm.
Okay. Who here...
Here we go. Sorry.
Who here has the lowest luck?
Yeah, right. Who here has the highest folklore or occult?
Probably. Yeah.
Probably.
I do have Cthulhu Mythos.
True.
Nope.
How many points? 12?
Ooh, you're good. Only 11.
I've got the lowest on everything.
Wait, so it was folklore too?
Folklore or occult.
Yeah. I have a basis for both.
Doctor?
I have... which one should I roll?
It's not a roll.
It's not a roll.
No. Alright.
it's just...
Just asking. Oh, just asking. Gosh.
Do you recognize what's about to come out in its eye?
Bobby, I thought that was just a fanciful tale.
Oh my god.
No, here it is, ripping my throat out.
Moving cabin in the woods. I always wanted to see a mermaid.
Oh my god, it's real.
Shit.
So, as you have maneuvered the stone off, the Shake stands and turns, and says in his mixture of French and English, slowly and patiently explains to you that the power of the sun has entered the Duat, or underworld, and lies there waiting for you to free it. But first, you must find the doorway to the land of the night.
Right. This is not it.
And the only way you can do that is through the Well of Stars, which grants a vision to those who know how to conjure up its secrets. As the sun moves behind a cloud.
Yep.
Somebody's gonna be eating that lotus.
So.
Ah!
The Shake reaches into his voluminous robes and withdraws a long, fluffy, brown ostrich feather and hands it to Dr. Fountain.
I accept the ostrich feather.
He mimes making a swirling action and pointing at the well.
Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and begin.
Okay.
Oh.
Pinky up.
Uh huh.
The symbol. Which direction?
Shit!
Thank you.
Direction. Okay, whatever.
All right. Whichever way that goes, yeah.
So starting from the outside in or inside out?
I'm starting from the inside out.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Spiral spread out.
So he's watching you and seeing that you're doing that, he's smiling and nodding encouragingly.
Good. Thank you, Chuck.
Mm-hmm. All right. So
I'm
yes.
Waiting for something to reach out and grab my arm.
Yeah.
So he says, "Good, good." The answers to your questions will appear in the ripples of the pond.
Okay, oh, correct. Okay. I'm gonna get my
everybody
gun
look.
Ready.
Oh, I forgot. Just ready.
Just ready.
Yeah. All right. So, Dr. Fountain, you are next to the well.
I am right over the well.
Is Captain Brett still next to the well?
Yeah, I imagine I would still maybe not be leaning over it, but standing by
uh-huh.
the lid. Uh-huh. Actually, if I was moving the lid.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Uh-huh. Yeah. That makes sense. Uh-huh. And then you said you're taking a step back.
You're standing back. Helga, yeah. I assume you're standing back.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. You both got your hands in it.
No. Yeah, basically yeah. hands on top of the
I'm standing
now.
More end of my...
The top flap has been loosened.
Exactly. Right. It's actually entirely off now, exposing exposing the grip.
Yeah.
My hand is in my handbag.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
Defenseless as a baby hanging over this thing.
With a feather.
With a feather. Even worse than a baby. I'm a grown man with a feather.
That is worse than a baby.
It is worse than a baby.
Alright.
I hope nobody sees me.
We're all seeing.
Your career will be ruined.
Y'all don't mind. Yeah.
So, after the Sheik tells you that, he begins chanting something under his breath.
Jesus. All
right, do you recognize it?
Do I recognize it?
It's
like, Atlantean?
It's musical.
Oh, okay.
It's some sort of prayer or something.
Oh, that's nice.
Mm-hmm.
If it's the last thing we hear alive, then
this is
fine.
Sure,
it's
haunting.
Mm-hmm. All right, so soon he trails off.
Okay.
You kind of sense that you can stop.
All right, so I stop, okay. Which is good because I'm getting a cramp.
So the ripples in the water die down.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you started, of course, it was you could see your reflection. You could see Captain Brett just off to the side. You could see the moon
yes.
above you. But now. You're looking into the water, you do not see your reflection. You see instead a vision.
Okay.
A massive sandstone facade supported by six pillars. Each of the pillars contains the carved head of a woman with cow's ears. Do you have any points in archaeology or history?
I do.
Okay, well, no role required.
No role required?
You recognize that as the goddess Hathor.
Oh, good old Hathor, she's the best.
The image then shifts to the ruins of this building.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
so there's a massive facade of
yeah.
six pillars.
Yep.
And Hathor's on the top of each one.
Yes.
Okay.
So then it shifts to reveal that this building is now lying in ruins.
Okay.
This facade.
Okay, now we're seeing it. Okay.
And it seems to be a temple complex.
All right, okay.
The ground splits open,
mm-hmm.
and the sun begins to rise through the crack in the stone flagging. So, Bucket and Helga, you basically see like sunlight coming up out of the well.
Ah.
And, like just illuminating this. These two both kind of recoil,
yes.
you know, from the brightness. You're both temporarily blinded, actually. It's like
mm.
having mm. a spotlight shown
sun.
Right in your face. Yeah.
Wow. Sun. Unexpected.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then it fades. And when your vision comes back after a couple beats,
mm-hmm.
You're looking at yourselves again, blinking.
Mm. Neat.
Where is
And then the Sheik is at your side, mm-hmm. daintily reaching over and taking the ostrich feather from your hand.
Okay. Where is the Temple of Hathor?
I bet our antiquary mentioned the museum
might know. That is very true.
Okay.
Well, we need to put the lid back on, right?
Mm hmm.
Oh, alright. I'll pull it back on.
I'll help.
Okay. Let's see.
I've already done that. Okay.
Mm hmm. Alright. Yeah, well, the lid is muscled back on.
Okay.
All right.
Give him the lotus.
What's our? Yeah, he already has the lotus, right?
He took the lotus.
Is he still there?
He's still there.
Thank you.
Another nod and a handshake.
Uh huh. Okay. There you go.
Yeah, he gave us what we needed to know. He gave us exactly what we needed to know.
Okay. So he smiles at you all and says, yes, you did very good. Very good. Very good. In order to journey to the Duat and face the challenges the gods have waiting for you, you must do as I say. Okay. However, be advised that your hearts will be weighed on the balance.
We're gonna die.
Only,
or go crazy.
You know, terrible shit lingering on your soul.
Yeah. I've got mostly a good heart, except for those people I apparently killed. That one time.
It was just that one time.
Just that once. So, yeah. Killed a lot of Nazis since then.
Yeah, makes up for it.
Yeah.
If you can defeat the dread Apophis,
okay,
the sun will be yours.
Alright.
You're good people. I can make for you the red ale of truth.
Mm.
This will help you in your journey to the Duat.
Okay.
We would greatly appreciate that.
Yeah.
The potion will be ready for you in the morning.
Excellent.
Okay. Quick. I hate the truth. Which you'll make from that lotus, I'm assuming.
Maybe. Maybe he just likes flowers.
It's a trade secret.
Yeah, maybe he does.
Trade
secret. Yeah,
it's a trade secret. All right.
Praise the sun.
You heretic.
Fuck the sun. Long live the fucking beast. All right. So, yeah.
Okay, back to the hotel.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. All right.
Now, on the way there, make a luck roll.
Well, you've got your guns, so you're given a wide berth even after sunset. And so...
Okay.
So Charles has his date in the morning. Mm-hmm. With a potential source of information about Temples of Hathor.
Exactly.
Ah, yes.
Anything else you guys want to do?
Dinner time? I don't know.
Well, sure.
Yeah.
Late night dinner.
Okay. Supper, really?
Yeah, sure.
There would be dinner. No, supper.
Whichever. Yeah. I'm going to make sure we have extra batteries for the torches this time.
Ha ha! Damn.
Failed again?
Anything for the right price, you say.
That's right.
Two torches for each of us, then. Batteries for everyone.
Maybe some flares, too.
Oh my god. Flares. Yeah. We love flares. Yes, all of it. All if it's flares. Burny, I want it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay.
See? I probably already have flares.
Emergency candles?
Yeah.
Glow sticks? Yeah. There are glow sticks, right?
Some sparklers.
Sparklers.
Fireworks! Let's just get fireworks for the other world.
Yeah. I would like to go to a nightclub and see a show.
Ooh!
Oh, I will set up two jars on my hotel room windowsill in order to collect the air of the unsubstantial ether of this area, and then I want to go to a nightclub.
Okay, great.
Well, that sounds like fun. Mind if I tag along?
Let's go.
Alright.
Oh, I wanna go.
Alright, it's a party then.
Yeah.
I can't get
it.
These are some dancers.
It's
really tasty,
Trey.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, if you like curry, then
yeah.
I don't really like curry. I just like
you still
that.
Like the
rubber? It's not too curry.
But it's got like a curry flavor to it. It's just...
Yeah, I actually really hate curry, but I don't like that one. Sorry.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, don't like Indian food.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, good. I thought I was the only one.
No, right? I'm like, everyone's like, I don't want to... I'm going to pretend you never told me that. Otherwise, we can't be friends anymore.
I know!
I really hate Indian food. I'm sorry.
You don't like it. How can you argue about something like that?
Yeah.
I just don't get why people get so passionate about
right?
it.
Right? I'm like, if I told you that I hated, like, I don't know, a steak, they're just like, oh, so you're vegetarian then. But, like, if I say I don't like Indian food, they're like, what the? Oh!
Son of a bitch!
My God, I can't believe I've wasted this much time on you already.
Yeah, basically.
It's those converts.
I don't understand.
It's okay.
I like Lassie.
Oh, well,
yeah, I like some of these.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. Curries.
But some people are just like human vacuum cleaners when it comes to.
Yes, is it the
way
that
it's served? Yeah, it's like it's the flavor. And also, every time I eat curry, I get like debilitating cramps in my kidneys. Like in my kidneys, or like in my back.
Oh, wow.
And they're like, oh, so it just makes you sick. I'm like, no, this is like not even intestinal. This is like.
Something bad.
Yeah. Like, yeah. India herself is punishing me.
Right, for something.
So, no,
I'm
sorry.
All right, so I'll go to the front desk and ask the concierge if maybe he can recommend something for someone who's from London and would like to see some of the local flavor.
Unless Lawrence recommended anything in particular.
Oh, that's right. Where's Lawrence staying? Does Brett know?
Oh, yeah.
If you had to make an educated guess, there's he might be staying in the barracks.
He is stationed here.
He is stationed here, yeah.
Okay, well, we could do that.
So. All right.
Yeah.
I think The Guide to North Africa is one of the few Octoon Cthulhu books I don't have in hard copy, so the concierge is currently downloading the PDF.
Very well then.
Just an idea. And the concierge's face having like the little circling rainbow thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's looking it up. All right. What kind of nightclub? Because I'm going to have a list to choose from.
Well, this is just a crazy idea. This doesn't have to.
Oh no, I love it.
Oh, okay. What is Cairo known for?
What's Cairo known for? Anything.
Well, I mean, I hear good things about this belly dancing.
This is a crazy concept.
Yeah.
It's
ridiculous.
Actually, it's not that crazy because already by this point in time, during the golden age of Hollywood, American cinema has already taken belly dancing from Egyptian cinema and transformed it into the sparkly rhinestone-y stuff that we know today.
Right.
Egyptians liked it, and so by this point in time, they're copying it. So it's actually American style in terms of costuming and the big orchestral bands.
All right.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Maybe we can see the authentic version of that.
Maybe.
Yeah. Actually, it's probably just going to be the big Hollywood version of it, because the
authenticity
is now kept to
you'd have to go
private households or weddings.
Right.
Oh, okay.
Or like a small town.
It's a crash or wedding, guys.
It's a crash or wedding.
Crash or wedding. Crash or Egyptian weddings.
I'm sure that won't end badly.
Really badly.
Oh, God.
So.
Alright.
I'm sure one of us has like a sword skill, right? When the cemeteries come out?
Nothing.
But actually, it's more likely to be the Asaya, which is the type of shepherd's cane that they use to defend themselves and their flocks.
I don't think you need to download that.
Pretty much, yeah. We're good.
No, who's going to know more than her? Nobody.
All right, well, very good.
Or, you know, little knives.
All right. Well, you hit up an appropriate club, whose name I'll have at some point here.
That's fine.
And, anything you want to do there other than just have a good time?
I can't shake these guys, can I?
Again, that's just so
what
I meant.
Oh, wow.
Whack.
You probably could.
Yeah,
you could. Whacking?
Yeah, I'm imagining you, like, whacking everyone with a book, just, like, beating.
Not.
Just so you can have a good time by yourself.
I need my load time.
Oh, shake. Something that, like, shake the, like, locals.
Oh, no.
Information.
Oh, no.
What?
No, I'm just trying to
No,
I'm just trying to give you the shake.
Oh, yeah.
I'm trying to have an actual good time.
Oh, my God.
All right. I'm going to go to the bathroom.
Oh, okay.
Whatever.
That's what he says before he disappears.
Yes.
He
disappears.
Yeah.
Excellent role playing, Jen.
Warming at last.
Oh, my God. All
right. Okay. You give him the slip.
Yep, give him the slip.
All right, what's up? What's up, Doctor?
We're talking about it at the table.
Do you want us to step aside?
You'll send me an email.
Yeah. We can.
No,
is it too much?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. Yeah. All right.
So she's gonna send you an email, David.
Yeah. All right. Okay. Anyone want to hit up any brothels?
No.
Okay.
No. That's in the handbook.
It's in the handbook? Yeah.
You don't do that.
No.
All right. Very well. All right. So, fair enough to say next morning?
Next morning.
Yep.
Okay. All right.
Wake up call gets me up at, 7:30 sharp.
Right.
I can, I can dress and shave and,
You're not already up at dawn?
On my best clothes. Well, no, I'm already up at dawn, but the 7:30 is just, like a backup.
Put on your best fez. Okay. Yeah.
And, I'll start making my way over to whatever her address indicates.
Mm-hmm.
So I can be there 10 minutes before 9 o'clock.
Okay. It's in the, still in the sort of European quarter.
Okay.
Portion of Cairo, so...
So what you're saying is I stand out still.
Yes.
Yeah.
And already this early in the morning, the streets are once again buzzing with activity. And so you find her modest little shop. Let's see here. It just says Curios and Antiquities.
Oh, her family's little shop.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And,
I have to awkwardly meet her dad.
Oh, God.
Oh, wow.
Probably.
Liberal!
So, stepping in through the door, a little bell chimes, and, she, comes out from the back, sort of tucking the last lock of hair into a bobby pin.
Mm-hmm.
Monsieur Bucket. Monsieur Bouquet. Monsieur
Bouquet. That was up.
Are you ready to go? I know a good cafe down the street.
I am. After you.
All right. So you see that she locks up as she leaves. Mm. Flips the close sign.
Yeah.
While you were in there, you had enough time to kind of get a sense of the place.
Yeah.
And, it's pretty sparse. Not a lot of product on the shelves.
Mm.
It's a front.
Yeah. So knowing what I know about fronts, since I was just in Italy, where there was that tea shop.
Yeah.
Does this kind of feel have sort of the same feeling?
Well, it's definitely unusual.
Mm.
It's like the time I walked into a chocolate shop with my friend who was shopping for a Valentine's gift for his girlfriend, and he asked the lady, for recommendation. She clearly didn't know anything about chocolate.
Oh wow.
So.
So I'll ask her.
Not know anything about chocolate.
She didn't even know anything. It's like, well, what's a good? Like,
I've never tried it.
Yeah, basically, it's like you work in a chocolate shop. So we walked out, and I'm like, that was a front.
Yeah. Yeah. What drugs were coming out of there?
Seriously.
Yeah.
Anyway.
So while we're walking to the cafe, I'll ask her if there's no one else in her family that can watch the shop while she's at breakfast.
Oh well, my parents are both deceased.
Oh. My condolences.
They both succumbed to the typhus epidemic 2 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
It's been a little hard.
I'm very sorry to hear that. It's tough losing family.
Indeed. But it is a beautiful morning, no? Mm-hmm.
It is. And where is this cafe you're taking me?
Oh, just right here.
Ah, lovely.
So you get seated.
Mm-hmm.
Small talk, etc.
Yeah, that's what you're. That's breakfast, etc. Move my way around to. So, while my colleagues were looking through some of the documents in the card catalog, they came across something that interested them about a temple to a goddess named Hathor. They were interested to see, I don't know, maybe they just missed it, but perhaps they were interested to see where that was.
Was it, six columns?
Yes, I think that's what they were, talking about, with a face.
Sure, yes.
On each one, yes.
Yes, it is a very famous, temple complex.
Ah.
It is south of here, near the,
near the town of Dendera.
Dendera. Mm-hmm. Okay. How many days travel?
Oh, it's, you could get a wagon-y, sleepier car. Mm-hmm. It's an overnight.
An overnight, okay.
Train ride. Mm.
Have you ever been?
No, I have not. Mm.
But, would you,
Monsieur Coutet has been, and he's told me many things about it.
Ah.
He's very well, learned man. Ooh. Is Monsieur Coutet.
Yes. How did you end up becoming his assistant?
Oh, I just love the subject. And, yes. So.
And you haven't been to the steppe. Would you like to come along?
Oh. Mm. I suppose I could close the shop for the weekend. Sure.
Oh my God.
So
to her impending doom.
yeah, she has signed
a date to doom.
Yes, I'm sure that once the professor hears that this temple is so close, he will try to organize one of those overnight cars forthwith.
Very good.
Did the professor come home with us last night?
No, he did not.
Did we hear him come in this morning?
No, you did not.
Was his sweet door closed? Did you see me?
I awakened in an alleyway.
Oh.
With all of my documents stolen.
Ah!
Oh my.
Yeah, yes. I wouldn't worry this email.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Oh, wow.
That's right.
I held on to the rubbings.
The rubbings.
Yep.
Yeah.
So I'm going to walk back to the hotel, and I should get there pretty soon.
You're going
to
do the walk of shame.
I'm walking all the way down.
Well, not like naked.
No, no, no. I have my outfit on.
Just, yeah.
Disheveled, though. Yeah. Yes. Hungover.
A little smelly.
Penniless. Yes.
Yeah.
So no wallet, no passport.
Nothing.
Okay.
Oh, my.
Now I got to get out of this.
All right. We'll find a way.
I know a spot.
Yeah.
I know a spy.
Yeah, you should get you some papers.
I'm imagining it's just like this is a test.
Yeah. You're in the headquarters of the State Intelligence Service. I'm pretty sure we're gonna get.
Yeah, we'll be fine.
You'll have to be British, but
I can probably get my own documents back again if I try hard enough.
Yeah,
the same crooks.
Can I just buy my passport back?
Buy my old damn.
Yeah. All right. So I'll just finish breakfast by regaling her with some stories from the brigade in Africa.
Mm-hmm.
And then, escort her back to her shop and then head back to the hotel with the information.
Okay.
All right.
When you drop her off, she gives you a little peck on the cheek.
Oh!
Looking forward to the trip.
Ah, lovely. I will walk away then with a spring in my step.
All right.
I'm smashing Leonardo DiCaprio. Like,
oh yeah!
Yeah. Yeah. The jaunty walk.
Yeah.
But you.
But me.
Yeah. I mean Charles Bucket.
Right.
Exactly.
Not Dave.
As you.
Not Dave.
Yeah.
Right. Or maybe does Charles Bucket space over your body?
Oh my God.
Wow. I don't know why I just did that.
Okay.
It did though.
All right, so tickets can be arranged after Bucket gives you the 411.
Okay, neat.
Dendera.
Yes.
Oh, Professor.
Yes.
Head back with us.
Quiet down.
Good
to have you back with us.
A coffee, Professor.
Yes.
Maybe some eggs.
Aspirin. Away we go. Yes.
Fried with some rashers of bacon.
Mm-hmm.
The thickest of toasts.
And onions.
Yes.
All of it. The most hangovery.
We'll put it in order with that restaurant.
Red Ale of Truth, we have to pick up, don't we?
Yeah.
That's right. You guys didn't pick that up while I was at my.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Go for a stroll.
Mm-hmm.
We can rewind a little bit.
While we're waiting for the professor to show up.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, what time did you wander in?
Just now.
Oh, okay.
This is me.
The same
thing
time
was at?
That's at 9 o'clock.
9 o'clock. So you're getting back around 9:45.
Yeah, so 10 o'clock?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So when would you have left?
We probably left at the same time Charles did.
So we're all coming back together right around.
We all meet in the lobby.
Exactly.
Okay. So, let's see.
Well, we would have to since you don't have your key anymore.
Oh, yeah.
That's right. Lost your hotel key, too.
Yeah. Oh, there you go. Okay.
Okay, so...
So, quick question. The hotel key, does it have the name of the hotel on it?
Oh, yeah.
We probably want to switch rooms. Just saying, because, you know...
Mm-hmm. So... Yeah, security covert. Is that what you mean?
Well, probably also, someone now has access to our room and knows what hotel our room is in.
So if nothing else, they can come and steal shit.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Like jars.
Probably be there.
Your ethereal jars.
Are your jars still there when you get there in the morning?
Sure.
Why not? Maybe.
Maybe that, like, the maid service, like, washed them out.
Oh, wouldn't that be funny? Let's say that happens. I come back.
Son of a bitch! What else could go wrong?
What a night! Yes.
Oh. Yes. Oh, man.
Oh, my God.
Right. Oh, and then that's when I'll drop my information. That's so I invited Micheline along with us to the temple.
You invited a civilian along with a covert government mission?
She seems to know a bit about archaeology and Egyptology.
You invited a civilian who's not cleared with to come on a...
Coffee spit take.
Like...
It's going
like a life or death, like...
We will be fighting Apophis.
Yeah.
She's gonna be...
What if her heart gets, like...
Exploded?
Doesn't make it, man. Yeah.
What if her heart tips the balance in the wrong direction?
Yeah. I mean, I don't know that it's probably that, you know, Anubis's jackals will eat the heart. But I'm just saying.
Yeah. No. Yeah.
I can imagine that's probably what will happen.
Possibly. Possibly.
She said her boss went there and he's fine. I'm sure she'll...
Go to the underworld part.
No, he didn't.
Well, no, but now she'll have something up on him.
That's true.
Maybe get a raise. If she gets back, of course.
I went to the underworld and came back. I deserve a 35-cent raise.
No, I went to the underworld and back. All I got was this. It'd be like a brooch or something.
Right, right. That's it.
All right, so the handoff of the Red Ale of Truth went fine. Basically, it's a gourd. Mm. You can hear liquid sloshing around inside.
Oh, okay. Do you have any further instructions?
He just says, pour out equal measures for everyone and knock it back.
We all have to do it?
All right. And do we do it at the temple, or when we get to the temple?
Yeah, definitely. Okay. Yeah. It wears off. Like, makes it so you just when you pee out the, you know.
The excess.
Yeah.
Hey, the pee will be red. It'll be fine.
No, but I'm saying...
Well, that's not a good thing.
When has red pee ever been
fine? That's never a good sign!
If you eat too many meats...
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, well,
yeah.
That's true.
All right, well said.
Well said.
But mostly, if we pee out the Red Ale of Truth, then maybe it won't work anymore.
Yeah, well, and do you really want to find out if it still works?
Yeah,
no, let's just drink it when we get there.
Yeah. All right, we'll save it.
Yeah, we'll do that. All right.
Like, maybe once we actually find the gateway to the underworld.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Well, it's right there.
And the sun starts rising.
Oh, it's just there.
Then we can drink
it.
It's there.
Yeah. Yonder.
Mm-hmm. Hold hell, right there.
Yeah.
Just yonder.
Oh, my God.
All right. Okay. Let's saddle up those horrible camels.
Actually, he does give you one piece
of advice.
Oh, God. Yes, here it is.
He says, keep your metal sharp. And do not be chained by thinking that willow is only of use for making cricket bats.
Wow, that is useless.
Good thing you weren't there.
I know, that would have ruined it. Old gibberish.
Good thing you were currently being beaten by cricket
bats.
Knives.
Yep, exactly. Knives. So I'm gonna go buy batteries and knives.
Batteries and knives, wow. Oof. I don't know what plans you have for tonight. Count me
out. Vodka diapers. I think I'll want to requisition like a bayonet for my rifle.
Yes.
I already have my bayonet, actually.
Yeah, it would be standard service issue.
Oh, you could have brought open the crates.
And I have a bayonet.
I guess I could have, yeah. Mm-hmm. Just didn't realize I had it on.
No.
Maybe you didn't have it on you, but it would be standard issue.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good.
Indeed.
So we all have our torches.
We're going to go fires.
Flares.
Damn it, I bought two for each of us, and now there's an extra person. She gets your torch, Bucket.
She gets mine. She can stay close to me.
Ayo!
Extra ammo for my gun.
I just thought to myself, what would make Lizzie really mad when she comes back next session?